Again?
I was in there earlier.
It's on my phone.
And they were practicing the intro. They were like, it's going to work. And they played it over and over again.
Patrick is not here today. Gus is not here today.
Yeah, but it hasn't worked in weeks.
And it was a bet of whether or not the intro would work.
It works when I was in there.
The intro did not work. We had no intro.
You know,
sing the
people...
song, Blaine. Go with the theme song. Hey! Like the way you ended that. That was a solid ending.
I'm Gavin.
Welcome to the RT Podcast. I'm Blaine.
I already said me.
I'm Barbara.
And I'm Burnie.
And I'm Blaine.
Whoa!
No, look at that, Blaine.
Really filling that seat.
Solid.
What's up, fellas?
What's solid. Gus?
Yeah, what are we going to talk about?
So today? Gus is out this week. You know what? I gotta say why Gus is out. I've made fun of Gus on the Rooster Teeth Podcast about this for years now, which is whenever Gus travels, he's the only person I know in the company who it not only his travel dates are his travel dates, but the days around his travel dates are also travel dates. Like, if we have to go on a business trip like Tuesday through Thursday, he will not come to the office on Friday. If we fly back like Thursday night in the afternoon, he can't come into the office the next day. Now he's going on a business trip tomorrow, but he's not doing the podcast tonight because he's traveling tomorrow.
Yeah, he's in town. He's at home right now.
Well, he was here today.
Yeah, that's why I asked him. I said, I thought you were out of town today.
Same.
No, I'm leaving tomorrow.
But it's dead easy to do like a half day. Like I did a half day. I took my suitcase to work and then went to Australia. But right. I had the morning at work.
Yeah, but his flight I think is at like 7 a.m. I get it.
Eh.
You want to pack?
What are you doing? Are you traveling this week for that thing? It's for the Dune
thing.
No, I'm
not.
I'm not going
to
go for that.
I was possibly going to be and then things changed and I didn't go.
So, who's a little bit jealous here? Are you going to the Doom thing?
Mm-mm.
So, like, they put together this whole big Doom thing with, like, all these sports stars and everything, like, Chad Ochocinco.
There's Ochocinco.
Ochocinco. And some soccer guy who everybody...
Thierry Henry, the most famous French man ever.
There you
Jack
go.
Not know who
I thought
was,
Napoleon was the most
Lafayette,
famous Frenchman.
You know, just throwing out a couple names there.
Oh, right.
Gerard Depardieu.
Look, Henry plays
French dudes.
Huh? Henry played for Arsenal, so I'm not that fussed by it. What?
Oh,
hey, there it is.
Sniper Wolf, hi.
Well, that intro works. The one we're jealous we're not going to.
Who's that hot
guy,
babe?
The football player who's with Michael.
That was a great fucking video.
What's his name, Gronk?
The Gronk. Gronkski, right?
What's funny is that Jack knew everyone except Thierry Henry, and he's the only one that I knew. I don't know anything.
But it's they're all going to be sitting down and playing Doom together, and that'll be like a big live stream. Starts tomorrow at...
It's Tuesday, May 29th at
5 o'clock Central.
Central. So
5 o'clock Central time.
Eastern.
Whereas right now, just for perspective, if you're watching this live, it is now 7:30 Central time. So it would be 2.5 hours earlier than right now if you're keeping score at home.
They already had
so
a thing.
So 21.5 hours away from now.
Yes. I also want to thank our sponsors for taking some time in Gus's chair today. I'm filling his role. I want to thank our sponsors from today. Our sponsors today are Harry's and Squarespace. So thank you very much, Harry's and Squarespace, for making this episode of the Rooster Teeth Podcast.
So the fact that Gus is in town means that tonight could have been the steak podcast.
That's another reason to be very mad at Gus.
Because I'm just very excited for steak. Like, it's so hard to be hungry for something weeks in advance, but I want steak.
Guys, this is making me feel very self-conscious, you know?
Oh, why? Because you're here and Gus is not?
Yeah, because it's like, God, it would have been so much better if Gus was here. And I'm like...
Well, I mean...
I really hope the control room pans.
He's kind of irrelevant. I just wanted the steak, to be honest. If you brought steak, I would like you more than Gus tonight.
I can order a favor.
Could you do it? Also, question. Since you've been so excited for the steak podcast, have you been avoiding all steak? Just to, like, prepare your stomach?
Not
and,
intentionally,
like,
but I haven't had a steak since.
So when we do it...
I will not have one until...
We're trying to organize it correctly, and hopefully we can do it next week.
Yeah, you got to be steak hungry.
So no favor?
I have to travel, but I worked around the podcast. So I
when are you traveling?
Next week.
You packed?
For next week? No. I pack, like, half
the
an
week
hour
off.
Before I go.
Yeah, me too. In fact, I forget stuff if I pack too far in advance. I'm most in the zone for packing, like... 10 minutes before I walk out the door.
I've really got to be such like a traveler where I can't be bothered that I'll show up to the airport 20 minutes before my flight boards. And I have just that amount of time. You're supposed to show up like an hour. And I'll just be like, I'm fine. I'll get on. Don't worry about
it. Well, here's two things.
You can turn that plane around. Come on back.
Two things that are very important about travel that once you think this way makes travel a lot less stressful. One, you only really need your passport.
You do.
You can forget everything else. Two, there's always another flight. And once you're not worried about either of those, it's like, it's so easy.
Do you know that that's also two very important rules for? The Amazing Race.
Yeah.
If you lose your passport, you are done. they're gone. There was a dude who, I think in season 18, he was in Russia and his passport was in a cabinet, pulled away. Like, they took his bag. He was done. And he was in, from what I read of interviews with him after the fact, the production just moved on because he was, like, eliminated right then. And he was in Russia for about 30 or 40 days with, like, no help or anybody trying to figure out how to get out via the American
embassy.
And
did he have his wallet or anything either?
No, everything was gone.
Did he have money?
No, everything's gone.
What about his partner?
I'm assuming the partner was with him. Can you hand me one of those beers? The non-shiner, please.
I went traveling recently, and I've been getting into this habit where I will work the day of my flight to the point where I bring my laundry up, and I'm always, like, stacking up laundry. Mm-hmm. So I will do my laundry up here at the office, and I will literally upend my laundry basket into a suitcase, and then just whatever that is, that's what I take on my flight.
So you come to that with an empty suitcase and dirty clothes.
Yeah, and then I'll just, like, dump it all in and be like, cool, ready to go. But my clothes
that's,
are always...
That's taking last minute to the next level.
Yeah, my clothes are always, like, wrinkly, though, but luckily, since I wear tight shirts, no problems.
Nice shirt, by the way.
Thanks, dog.
That's a new shirt tomorrow.
Yeah, Blaine's the worst model for shirts because you can never read what they're supposed to be. His body just crushes shirts. There we go.
Rips it off.
That's a filthy casual shirt. Very,
we
very
should
trendy.
Make like a pec friendly shirt for you. The way like your tits.
So you should
don't,
just wear
like,
a female size shirt.
Yeah. No, it should just be it should be like one of those Batman molded suits, and you just wear that like a neoprene one.
Yeah. Can we sell like a Blaine shirt that has like muscles molded onto it
and little nipples?
Yeah.
Not that you have nipples, but they are always on Batman suits.
My nipples.
See, I mean, I'm sure you have nipples. I'm feeling like I'm digging a hole here, Blaine. But so you have nipples. I'm just saying nipples aren't an issue with you.
No, I'm better at this game.
Yeah, he's pretty close. It's down here. They go low.
They go low. Yeah.
They go low.
Can you explain that game to everybody?
Nipple? You guess the nipple.
Here's what I think. I think Gavin plays that game in the hopes that one of his female friends will let him try it on her. Has it ever worked for you?
I've never tried to poke a girl's tit. I'm trying to like identify where her nipple is.
But you just here. Give it a shot. So in your shirt, he'll walk up to you like at a bar or something. Where you're wearing your shirt, and he'll do this. You know exactly what he's about to do if you know Gavin. He comes in with his finger, and you know he's just going to try to guess where your nipple is on your chest.
And it starts a game, because then they try on you.
Yeah.
A lot of people are terrible. You know who's not terrible? You know who the best in the world at this game is?
Let me think about that. Ryan.
Esther Sorolla.
Really?
Yeah. She's never missed my nips.
She's tuned in.
Yeah.
That's a shirt.
She knows exactly where they are all the time.
She's never X-ray missed vision. My nips.
That's how she found out she has X-ray vision.
But she married Gus.
In the Batman Superman movie, which we might talk about. We want to talk about it right now so we can get like any kind of like...
Non-spoiler. Let's say that. But
what were you going to say?
Addressing issues, though.
They used a lot of stuff in Superman. In Man of Steel, does this Superman not have X-ray vision?
What, because they use smoke on it?
Yeah, and they used smoke on him.
Well, Batman did, and then there was also
he used
that
a smoke
scene.
Bomb and got away from
well,
it.
Well, the smoke bomb that is green, you can understand it messes with him. But then he just used a normal smoke bomb.
And he flows through it. Yeah.
Where'd it go? That was early in the movie before there was any green stuff, though.
Yeah. Also, the first green thing he grabs, because he's Superman, amazing reflexes. The second one, he just flies right into it.
Yeah.
It's like, why didn't he just dodge it? He can see in bullet time. Why did he even...
It's so tough when it's Superman. Well, he had been affected already.
So,
oh, look at this.
And I thought Ben Affleck did a great Batman.
Yeah, that's pretty good.
But Batman was fucking stupid in this movie.
Yeah.
What was that email to that?
Oh, dude. We should probably let's do this post show. This post show, we'll talk all about spoilers about Batman and Superman.
Great.
Okay. All
right.
So we'll do that. So apologies. The post show has kind of become the place where we do all of our spoiler talk. Knows. I'm kind of working on something though to change that. I'm going to try a little different thing.
I will say this though. I like Man of Steel better.
Coming soon. You like Man of Steel better than Batman versus Superman.
Yep.
I will say this, and I don't think it's a spoiler to say this because I complain about this with every fucking Batman movie and every fucking Superman movie, is I don't want to see the Batman origin story anymore. I'm done with it.
You don't want to see a kid crying over two corpses ever again?
I'm fucking done with that origin story. Or at least he can cry or like a flashback where he remembers it or something. They got to walk us through the whole fucking thing. And it's like, as someone who's going to direct Batman movies in the future, I'm sure somebody's out there who's going to direct one sometime in the future. Unless you're going to do something dramatically different with that, don't fucking shoot it. I don't care about like your vision of the alley and the gun and the mom and then the pearls. It's like you're not going to shoot the pearls in a unique way that's really going to set people back on their heels.
Although the pearls were pretty cool in this one.
It's been done. It's all been done.
You see IMAX TV?
No.
Ironically, the dude who played, cool. What's Bruce Wayne's dad's name? Thomas, thank
Thomas
you.
Thomas Wayne and Martha Wayne.
Biggie Wayne.
The dude Martha who played Wayne. Him was the comedian from Watchmen.
Watchmen.
And that actually did have an interesting take on the Batman origin story in the opening credits.
The comedian from Watchmen?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Wasn't he like 50?
Oh, no. They used aged makeup. That guy played...
Am I right? Am I going to see it? It's the comedian from Watchmen,
it's,
right?
Yeah, and
the
then, guy that and gets, then it's...
Yeah. There you
Something
go.
Morgan?
It's that, and then it's Terry the chick. It's the chick from, or it's the woman from Walking Dead as well.
They're both in Walking Dead.
What? Yeah. It's the mom.
The mom Dead? Was in Walking Dead. She's the one that's dating, that other guy that everybody loves.
Glenn. It's Maggie.
Yeah.
That was.
She looked good.
Really, she's beautiful. A good-looking girl. She's like on the cover of like all those like rip like shape magazines.
Yeah,
you,
I know.
You buy the ones that probably have the dude with the fucking arms like this. Have no you ever comment. Seen, like, all the people when they get on those Muscle and Fitness mags, how they all complain about how those are probably the most Photoshopped covers of all time? Like, Andy Roddick, when they put him on the cover of that, he's like, look at this. He goes, my bicep isn't anywhere close to this. He goes,
really?
It's ridiculous.
Do and they then, also grease him up in Photoshop?
Yeah. And, like, Daryl from Walking Dead, he's on the cover of one of these things recently, and his arm is, like, easily 4 times the size it is on the show every week.
That dude's blown up.
I wonder how big Blaine would be on a magazine cover.
Dude, you should do it. He's swole as
yeah,
fuck.
Let's give it on a magazine cover. Lighting is key. You always had the top lighting because it hits the abs, and then it's like, shadows, and it's like,
But wouldn't you want the underlighting for your biceps?
When it hits my abs, it's not shadows, it's just shadow.
It's all in the light.
I got the one back. That's all I have. It's nice that you have shadows. I'm really proud of you.
So if you, in 2045, the Batman reboot is given to you. You got to start Batman again. How do you shoot it?
I'm not doing the origin story. Maybe,
first person perspective.
Every time.
Hardcore Batman.
It's Superman too. And it's not just those two characters either. If I go to the Civil War Avengers and they show Spider-Man's origin story, I will walk the fuck out. I mean... That we have seen that fucking origin story a billion times.
Kid gets bit by spider.
I don't think this is a spoiler either.
Or Ben.
For dying. Batman versus Superman, because she's all over the trailers. But Wonder Woman is in the movie.
Yeah, she is.
She is. And it's like, hey, we really want to do an origin story in this movie. It's like, oh, do you want to make it the origin story for the character who's never appeared on screen before? Nope, Batman. It's like, they didn't say anything about Wonder Woman.
Yeah.
At all. Like, they purposefully... There's only one little tiny shred of information you get about this character.
Yep.
You get nothing. Anyway, we'll do a whole spoiler cast later. Sorry.
But the actress that played her.
Gal Gadot.
God damn.
Yeah.
You like
that
her?
That is a good looking woman.
I liked her better not as Wonder Woman. I mean, I thought she was a cooler character when she wasn't Wonder Woman.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, just looks
I was about to say when she was Linda Carter.
She was also on the 56-mile-long runway in Fast and the Furious.
What is Wonder Woman's alias?
What is her secret identity? Prince. Diana Prince.
Wanda
Diana
Woman.
Prince, Diana, that's right. Is it Prince?
It's Prince.
Wanda
Prince?
Woman.
Like P-R-I-N-C-E.
Not like Freddie Prinze? She's not from the Prinze family?
Like the name Wanda.
Oh, yeah, I got it.
Thanks.
You want me to look that up? You don't look sure of yourself.
What? Diana Prince?
Diana Prince. That is right. Diana Prince.
Yeah.
Damn.
I think that, like...
I'm going to go to Twitter.
Future generations are going to look at Batman kind of like... Okay, so we have Star Wars... 4, 5, 6, and then they had the prequels 1, 2, 3, which are significantly worse. I think that they're going to look at
your opinion.
Batman Dark Knight trilogy, you know, like the Nolan trilogy. It's like, oh yeah, those were the good Batman movies. And then they kind of got really shitty with Man of Steel. And
you don't think they were shitty with George Clooney?
No, they're pretty shit. 89 Keaton Batman was fucking cool, but it got all Schumacher-y there.
He was a two Batman.
89
right?
and 90 or 91. With Penguin and Catwoman.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I don't know.
Batman, it's hard to keep track of all the Batmans.
How hard is it to get fucking Batman right?
I like the one with Jim Carrey.
The one with Mr. Freeze.
I read a quote the other day about Tommy Lee Jones hugging Jim Carrey, and he like whispered into his ear, and he's like, I hate you. I can't stand you. And then he said something along the lines of, like, I cannot... like warrant your buffoonery or something. Some like really eloquent way of saying he was just a jackass.
So Tommy Lee Jones. To Jim Carrey?
Yeah, to Jim Carrey.
That's so harsh.
Well, yeah. I mean, it's probably true.
Yeah.
Probably annoys the shit out of people.
Yeah.
Someone is trying to tell me that Superman uses a lead, or excuse me, Batman uses a lead-based smoke.
So
whatever that means. Whatever that means. But he doesn't use X-ray vision. At any point in... Does he do it in Man of Steel?
Well, you assume he's using it because he finds people, like, come straight Lois. Through the ceiling.
Yeah. Well, then they're also, like, if you think about it, when he's looking through his glasses, I bet he uses a little x-ray vision to see through those glasses. Otherwise, you know, because when he wears the Clark Kents.
They're clear. So, is that what you mean by x-ray?
Maybe they have prescription in them.
Why would he get glasses with him?
Because he's got to conceal his identity. And he's not going to get just, like, UV-protected glasses. Like,
you don't know that.
Yeah, but he would get glasses like yours, where it makes the middle of your head look super pinched. Like, look straight at the camera. Look at the camera. You can see the gap on either side of your head in your glasses. Like, look straight ahead. Look right at the camera. There it is right there. There's two black gaps, one on either side. Your head goes like an hourglass.
You look like the liquid inside a milk bowl.
Like, do my eyes get bigger or smaller when I...
Look at me, looks right
at it. They get bigger when you take them off two times.
Wait, instead of pulling them up, just put them towards the camera slightly.
What's happening?
They're getting tiny.
Your eyes are getting more apart. His eyes are staying in the center, though. That's really weird. You almost got to the point where you did multiple eyes.
Well, hello, podcast viewer. I know this is the middle of the podcast, so I apologize for interrupting. But I wanted to let you know that with sponsorship, you get a ton of cool stuff. You get live stream podcasts every Monday at 7:30 Central. You get everything else live streamed. You get bonus content and tons of other features on the site and 5% off our store at all times. So click the link right here and start your free 30-day trial right now. And after you do that, I'll let you watch the podcast again. So click it. Now. Okay.
So what would contacts look like for you? Would it be like
normal?
Like a steampunk movie with like the rotating pieces and the huge monocle?
My eyes are fucked.
You have contacts.
What is your vision? Do you know?
-7, 7.5 or something like that.
I don't know what that means. I asked a question now. I don't even know the answer.
Do you have perfect vision now that you had LASIK?
Yeah, I think I do.
Because I know some people get it and they still need glasses.
Do they just do it in your head, like in your eye? Or do they have to cut your eye off?
Yeah, Toby Turner just did a video showing his LASIK that he got.
Oh, gross.
And, why?
I don't know why. I warned him right before we did it, too, that's like the one thing nobody prepares you for when you get your surgery.
The stink?
Is you can smell your eye burning. That's not a smell that you're really prepared for.
Chris Damaris, like, is all about savings. Like, I remember one time he got sick because I think he had, like, grocery store sushi that was free. Well, anyways, Chris is, like, all about savings. So I remember he was, like, the day before he was going to get LASIK. Yeah, he's very cheap. But he's, like, he's very smart with his money.
Thrifty?
Yeah, that's the word for it. So he, actually, I remember he called the LASIK company that he's about to get a surgery with. He's like, hi, I'm Chris. I have an appointment tomorrow. I work for a production company, and we have this show called RT Life.
Wow.
And I was wondering if I could get, like, a discount if we promoted your service.
He's using RT Life for personal gains.
Yeah, you just outed Chris in a big way.
I mean,
it's just like, you know.
That's actually a big deal. Well, that really is, that Chris called and tried to get a discount.
Yeah.
In order to shoot an RT Live somewhere?
You know, it's like, shit. I'm sorry, Chris. Uh-oh. I'm sorry, Chris. This is really awkward. I didn't know that was a big deal.
That is, that's a conversation that we'll
Blaine
have.
Didn't know it was a big deal. What have you done, Blaine?
We went skydiving.
Skydiving.
Although that was for a Rooster Teeth production.
No, I mean, yeah, skydiving and, like, laser tag and...
You should disclose all that.
We've done a lot of fun stuff.
I mean, I don't know. And now I feel bad.
What was the skydiving for?
Skydiving was for RT Recap. But it was like... We didn't really need to go skydiving for RT Recap, but I was like, I think it'd be a cool way for us to go skydiving.
That's a little different. It's like you didn't end up with a car or new eyes or a plastic surgery procedure at the end of it.
Well, I mean...
That's a little different.
Oh, God damn it. This is really awkward.
Yeah, just wait, Seth. It's okay. You'll be at the hearing. It'll be fine. You'll just have to testify. It'll be fine.
Yikes.
People keep telling me about Spider-Man. They keep saying that...
Spider-Man,
that this is Spider-Man's first time ever in the Marvel Universe, so it's very appropriate if they show his origin story. No, it's not. It's really not.
Everyone knows it.
Everybody fucking knows it, and you should not waste screen time with that fucking origin story.
And if you don't know it, Google it.
With the fucking bit by the spider and all that stuff. I just don't... I've seen it. We all know
it. How is there only one Spider-Man?
What does that mean?
Well, there's tons of spiders from that place.
We're the Spider-Man.
But only one... How many people do you think get bit on a daily basis by spiders?
Spider-Woman.
A spider factory? Well, not factory, like lab? I don't know. What was the place?
I always thought how lucky it was that Spider-Man developed spider agility and the ability to, like, latch onto stuff, as opposed to, like, getting eight eyes on top of his head. That would have been way worse.
Man-Spider. Isn't that what that guy is called?
We're going to get back into...
Or am I thinking of Man-Bat?
We're going to be getting back into Superman versus Batman territory here really fast, so let's just go.
Can Spider-Man... Because in Tobey Maguire, he shoots web out of his skin.
In Tobey Maguire, okay?
All right. But in
my favorite movie of all time, Tobey Maguire, featuring Spider-Man.
In other guy, in an English guy Spider-Man, he just builds a thing that shoots web. It's not in him.
Well,
wait. I can't wait. I want to watch this movie, Tobey Maguire. Coming soon, Tobey Maguire, to theaters everywhere.
I think he
produces... He was just an average Spider-Man working at the Spider Factory. When suddenly, web shot from his wrists. See Tobey Maguire, featuring Spider-Man, this fall.
I can't breathe.
But anyway, it was like, which one's the real one?
Well, in the comics,
his tears all down to your mouth.
In the original comics, Spider-Man, he was a nerdy, super smart kid, so he built his own web shooters.
Oh, okay.
And in fact, they would run out. Like, he had little cartridges, and he would run into problems all the time because he'd run out of web.
So Amazing Spider-Man was the comic Spider-Man.
Amazing Spider-Man was a comic Spider-Man.
And Tobey Maguire Spider-Man.
He produces his web, but doesn't he have to, like, take it out and then he puts it into the cartridges?
I believe, no, not from what I understand.
No, I'm pretty sure
he's just secreting into a jar.
Where does he make it from? I've never seen a thing where he's, like, pulling web out of his butt.
I'm not crazy.
Like a spinneret.
It would come out of his butt. He would shit web, wouldn't he?
He'd take web dumps. Yeah, it wouldn't come out of his wrists.
And then he shits into a jar and then shoves it in his wrist.
They'd make the swinging through the city really funny, though, because he'd be going butt first everywhere. He'd be, like, hanging straight down.
And then he'd make fart noises every time he'd...
What about that scene where he kisses Kirsten Dunst really funny? He comes down, like, all four.
Can someone recut one of the trailers with just fart noises for
all
the
web
shoot?
What should we use to settle this argument here, Blaine? Should we use Wikipedia? Is that okay with you?
For what?
Look up Spider-Man and see the web shooters?
Marvel Wikia.
Marvel Wikia?
Marvel.wikia. I think that's the thing.
Or just Wikipedia.
Web shooters. You guys are going to have to talk. It's going to take me a little bit of time to find this. Never mind. I can't find it. Anyway, from what I understand, they were always mechanical. When did you start reading Spider-Man?
Oh, I don't read. Yeah.
What are you talking about then? Why are you correcting me if you don't read?
Because, like, I like read all the wikis and stuff like that. Because okay. Here's my thing. I do read comic books. I read.
I was gonna say you have comic books.
I'm entirely caught up on all canon Star Wars novels.
Wow.
And books. Like,
that
I have
not
every
count.
Single one of them.
That is not a comic book.
And they're all bored and bound. What do you mean they're not a comic?
That's not a real comic. Well, they made a comic based on a movie. That's not a comic.
Comic is like comic first.
Yeah. Superman's a comic.
Well, I just got my. Dick slapped.
Oh, you'll be fine.
Well, so I read all the Star Wars comic books, and I take offense to that. But since there's, like, years, since I'm a completionist, and there's just years of backstory for, like,
By the way,
Thor,
the Marvel Wikia on Spider-Man has that much information. That's it.
Really?
No,
like,
it doesn't.
Three tiny
Is
little
Is that the Marvel website's one?
They can't be all
You're
of Spider-Man.
You're making a mistake.
On
I'm
Marvel
on
Wikipedia.
Long story short, there's too much backstory. I don't want to get caught up on it all, because it would take forever and take a lot of money, so I... Just
comics at this
don't.
Point, because they're so old, they're like 60, 70 years old. Like, each character's been played by, like, so many different characters, and, like, people have died and come back to life. Like, how many Batman and Robins have there been in the comics? Like, a ton of them, right?
Yeah.
Like, Robins have died.
What do you mean? Multiple Batman?
I mean, Tim Drake, I think, took on the role of Batman. Dick Grayson. Oh,
yeah,
Dick Grayson.
Dick Grayson. And then when Bane
some
broke
point,
his back,
at
right?
some point, like...
I'm fucking Google in the control room today.
I know, right? You guys
and
are
at some point,
it.
One of the Robins became the Joker or something? Is that right?
I think that was in the animated series.
Dude, we're just killing
I'm
it.
Getting a
if
nod,
are mad
yes.
Red Hood, talking about science, the Red Hood? Are you mad about it? I actually don't know DC that well, which is why I didn't want people to think I was just complaining about...
What does it stand for?
DC... Direct to You Comics.
Dick Cock. What?
Wait, what is it, Kid. Actually? Direct? It's not direct.
I don't know what it is. I said it with confidence. What is it? What is it, Gavin? I don't know
what
DC
stands for.
Anybody know what DC stands for?
Detective Comics.
Oh, because that's where they debuted everything.
I had no idea. I never even thought about it. I never was like, I don't know, DC stood for
it's
something.
That's why you look up, like, Batman's
comic
first appearance
fans at
Detective
home right
Comics.
Now, just fucking ripping their hair out.
That's what I'm saying.
They're just not accessible without buying a bunch of tiny books.
Yeah.
You need, like, to be filled in. There needs
you
to be, like, a round.
You can't access comics
right
without accessing
here.
Comics.
John Reisinger knows. He should be on Talk About Comics.
We've done, like, sponsor-only comic podcasts before.
Comic casts.
Yeah.
I think those are still on the site somewhere.
It's taking me fucking forever to look at the Spider-Man web shooter thing. I don't know why I'm doing this, because you don't read the fucking comics.
Just
you're
skip
making
all
me
the Spider-Man stuff.
Anyway.
Spider-Man off on Twitter.
So, when they made Tobey Maguire have the organic web shooters, that was a really interesting choice, because
organic.
It kind of took away from the mystique of Peter Parker, like, inventing his own stuff and being this nerdy science kid.
Like, it just came out of him.
Yeah, it was just like...
He was, like, shooting loads all over the bedroom and, like, pulling stuff down.
It would be tough to go through puberty with the organic web shooters.
I remember that scene. That definitely had some, like, you know, reference to puberty.
I don't think it did.
I'm just imagining him with another woman, and he finishes, and it's like these giant spider webs that come out like on her tits.
Oh God. Okay.
But yeah, like, he was
Chris is calling me.
Disguised Peter tested his newfound abilities, defeating professional wrestler Crusher Hogan in the ring and earning some cash. Using his scientific prowess, he constructed a pair of artificial web shooters that attached to his wrists. With an agent, a costume, and a new name, Spider-Man became an overnight sensation on television. So artificial web shooters means the web was artificial as well. Otherwise, why put artificial in there if he built these things? So I don't think he was like pulling web out of his ass and then shoving it into the web shooters. And then firing it at people.
Think so.
I really don't think so.
Well, that would have meant that he got heavier the moment he became Spider-Man.
Why, Gav?
Because web was being made.
Well, how much do you think web weighs? Like, I think it's like...
Well, that's Matt and Anna.
Then he was microscopically heavier.
Take this mic away from you. You have to earn the mic. Next, again, you can't have it right away.
But like, he didn't have a gland in his body.
60 second time out.
That took like nutrients from his food and turned into web. He just like had web all of a sudden.
Yeah, well, that might have taken time. I don't think like as soon as he got bit by, like the spider comes down, lands on his wrist, bites him.
I thought it bit his head.
It bit his head?
Didn't it bite by the back of his neck?
The picture's always like, in the comics, at least Peter Parker like this, and the fucking wavy lines coming off of his hand. And so it bit him, and then the moment the spider bit him, it goes, ow, oh, my ass is full of web. That would be a really fast transformation.
It's like when all of a sudden you have to shit, and it's like that gurgle you get in your stomach.
Go ahead.
Bloop. You know that one.
The one I get in my stomach?
Yeah, or anybody's stomach when you have to shit all of a sudden.
I see. When you're filled with web.
Have you ever been about to throw up, but it turns out you just needed a poo?
Yeah.
What?
Yeah.
No.
I
think it was where I was like...
Are you shitting on your mouth?
Where I was like, I'm going to throw up. And then I was like feeling a bit tummy weird, so I was like, let me get this out first. Took a dump, felt fine afterwards.
Yeah, it's just like the sickness inside you wanting to get out.
It was pushing my food up.
You people are fucking nuts. That's all I got
to
say.
This is the closest I ran to like running away for a podcast because I had to shower because I just got back from the gym.
Yeah.
But I was like, oh, I got like 3 minutes to take a poo. And I did it, and I'm so glad I did because I was like so at ease. You know like that good, fresh feeling you have right after you've emptied? Yeah.
It's a great feeling. It's up there with like eating.
Oh, are you going to do an ad read?
Speaking of good, fresh feelings, have you ever asked yourself why razors are one of the only products in the drugstore that are locked inside a plexiglass case? When you stop and think about it, it's because razors are so overpriced that people are actually more likely to steal them than just about any other product in the drugstore. Good razors cost too much, which is why two guys like you started Harry's.com. They sell high-quality blades that provide a close, comfortable shave for half the price you're used to. You know, I think the best example of how expensive blades are? You ever seen that image? And I definitely do this. When you buy a four-pack of razors, and the first one lasts you about a week, the second one lasts you about 2 weeks, the third one's a month, and the fourth one is like 6 months that you like use that last one. It's like this escalating process by which you just hold on to those razors because you know you're going to be out like $20 whenever you buy another four-pack.
Yeah.
How often do you buy razors?
This might be embarrassing. I don't shave as often as I should because I have blonde hair, so it doesn't show up very much.
Okay, Harry's is the only shaving company that has both amazing quality and low prices. Their five-blade cartridges are German-engineered and quality is guaranteed. Their factory-direct prices cut out the middleman and ship right to your door. Harry's starter set, called the Truman, is a great option for new customers and an amazing deal. For just $15, you get a razor handle, moisturizing shave cream, and three of Harry's five-blade German-engineered razors. Plus, there's a special offer for fans of the Rooster Teeth podcast. Harry's will give you $5 off your first purchase with the promo code ROOSTER. So go to harrys.com right now. That's HARRYS.com. And make sure you use the code ROOSTER at checkout to let them know who sent you. And thank you very much, Harry's, for making this possible.
Thanks, Harry.
Speaking of things that are hairy, Barb, yeah. You want to finish your thought?
Well, I don't shave as often as I should, and razors are expensive. So I usually only buy one maybe every month, 2 months or so.
So one razor at a time? You should go to Harry's.
No, well, yeah.
I'm here to clear Chris's name.
Oh, are you?
Yes, because I remember that's when I was producing, and we were talking about this before the podcast. Remember when I was saying, when I was producing RT Recap?
He's mad at you.
I was like, every time I'd be like, fuck, what am I going to do this week? I remember... He was going to go get his LASIK, just normal, and I was like, hey, let's do an RT recap about that. And I was like, oh, yeah, let's do that. So then he was like, okay, well, maybe I can call. I could get a discount from him, too. So then he called, and he was like, hey, can we film it for the show?
So it was your fault.
So it was my fault.
How is that
so
different?
Fire me. Please don't fire Chris.
You'll see. We'll see.
Don't, please don't get mad at Chris.
He'll half fire both of you.
That was a startling piece of information that I received earlier today.
But it was
Chris. People are disagreeing with me about origin story. Somebody on Twitter said, his name is Chris H. Swift. He incorrectly stated on Twitter, I disagree with you, Burnie, about origin stories. A story needs to stand on its own. You can't neglect important aspects of your character. If you're at the third fucking movie in a trilogy, you can take the other things that happened in the trilogy as being part of the canon of that trilogy. This is now, if this is Man of Steel, we've seen the Christopher Nolan movies, we've seen Man of Steel, we've had Superman's origin story, and we've had Batman's origin story covered many times in this generation of movies. We don't need it again. We don't fucking
also,
need it.
Also, even in, like, Superman Returns, the one before Man of Steel.
Right.
Even though it was meant to be a sequel, we still had an origin story of him, like, crash landing back to Earth. Even though
every
he was, like,
director
a regular...
just wants to show that origin story.
Yeah, he crash lands again in, like, his original place where he hit, but he's, like, a fully grown man.
Let's say we make the Laser Team 2. We don't need to show us finding the... Well, I shouldn't say that, because we'll probably put that scene in. You know, but I'm saying, like, we wouldn't need to do the whole scene all over again.
You should just...
Unless there's some new information there.
So, the Hulk, I think when they did the Incredible... I can't remember which one it was. What was the skinny guy that did the Hulk? It was before
Edward
Ruffalo.
Norton?
Yeah. Okay, Edward Norton. That one, they just covered his origins in, like, the title sequence.
Yes.
Like,
over, it was montage.
Just do that. Was Ang Lee that directed that one.
Yeah, right? Ang Lee did the one with Bana.
Oh, he did the one with Bana?
Eric Bana.
Uh-huh.
And then they did the Edward Norton one, which I can't remember who the director
was. All right, I got to save. I'm going to write down this thought, too. You just reminded me of another thought I want to talk about with the...
Burmern.
The thing
which Hulk had the guy from Hardcore Henry in it?
Wait, say again?
The guy from Hardcore Henry?
Oh, no. Yeah? Yeah, that was
Charlton Copley?
No, not that guy.
Hugh Jackman.
What?
The guy that was his dad.
Yeah.
That was the Edward
Tim
Norton
Roth.
One.
Tim Roth.
Yeah.
That's what he said that reminded me of that was there's a character in that I got to talk about with Superman versus Batman. So I just remember that.
Okay. We'll talk about it later.
Okay. Right, enough talking about the fucking superhero movies because we're gonna talk about it later.
You guys are the one who keep bringing it up.
That's his fault.
I was getting really annoyed in my dream the other night.
You look at Blaine calling out for the audio podcasters.
What did I do?
You called it out, like who I was pointing at. That was very nice of you to do that for the audio listeners. Gavin, you had a dream last night.
Well, I was getting annoyed because everything in your dream is like your brain trying to make sense of just random firings of, you know, brain shit.
Yeah, right? That's why it worried me that one time Gus had a dream about me on a Sunday and he hadn't seen me in 3 days. I was like, why was like I still on your mind? Yeah, this thing.
I had a dream I broke a lens, right? So I had to replace the lens. But I first tried to fix the lens I broke. And I was putting it back together. And this, like, yellow clip thing. I remember the shape of it. I could draw it. It was, like, semicircle sticking out and, like, a right angle down and a bit at the bottom. And for some reason, I couldn't put this lens together because I couldn't get this stupid yellow clip to fit inside it. And then, like, I went about my dream, came back to it. I was like, this damn clip again. And I was like... My brain has invented this thing that I can't figure out.
Yeah.
And I know, and it made the shape of it.
I love it.
Just to piss me off. And it was like really consistent throughout the dream. The same shape thing. I was like, what does this mean now? Now I want to print it out on a 3D printer and be like, what does this mean? Like, I couldn't do what I wanted to do in the dream because of this item
and
that I made up.
It's funny because your brain just like made up a frustrating shape.
Yeah, it made up the situation.
The brain is its own audience.
And it made up the thing that... You know, caused me a lot of grief.
It's like I was
really annoyed about it.
By design, it said I need to make a shape that's annoying to myself. That's this shape, so here it is.
Yeah.
You know? And it could have been anything, it just assigned annoying to that.
The dream may have been as well because I totally ruined one of our lenses.
Look at you. What, after the dream?
I know what this is based on. I was shooting the other day, I was shooting a short with Chris, and I'm sitting there and I'm looking at them setting up the camera with the lens. It actually might have been $1 million, but and I'm looking at this lens because I'm right next to it and I'm like, the fucking lens is a wreck. It's covered in paint. And I was talking about how when we first got this equipment, we were like taking it out of the cases like so carefully and setting it down and everything. And now I'm looking at this lens, it's like dinged and chipped and everything. I'm like, and then it's covered in paint. I'm like, that's a fucking slow-mo guy. Yeah. Shoot.
Was it one of those red lenses?
So all I did was take a picture of it and send it to Gavin and he's right back, sorry. That's it. Didn't even need to explain what it was.
The paint was all me. The ding and the chip, I mean, I take care of the lens, but you can bag the camera and you can bag the top of the lens. But you still need to see through the glass.
Right.
And I didn't have any optical flats. So some paint landed like in the catchment rim. Didn't go on the glass. It just like went all inside. And then you try and rub it off and it's
a pretty normal thing to put plexiglass in front of.
Yeah, I just didn't have any.
Yeah, there you go. Why would you for a slow mo guy shoot? But, you guys very rarely do stuff
it's crazy.
Where shit flies everywhere. Why would you take the time to buy a $2 sheet of plexiglass?
Is that how much it is? No, you need like proper like optical bucks. Flat. Otherwise it goes all like...
The most dangerous slow mo guys you've done. What has it been?
Dangerous?
Something with fire, I assume, right?
I stood downwind from Dan firing a flamethrower a couple of weeks ago.
I think you said you stood downwind from Steve-O.
Also dangerous.
It can be very dangerous. Yeah, that can be carcinogenic.
Dan fired a backpack-mounted flamethrower right at me.
You were saying, I thought, wasn't that legal? You got that, like, figured out? Yeah. No, it was, like, legal. It was just, like, there was something about it that wasn't...
We just couldn't shoot it where we shoot, because it's...
Yeah.
So dry?
It's, like, you need a fire marshal and stuff.
Oh.
Turns out we just shot somewhere else. It's all good.
Is that out yet?
No. That might be the next one.
Okay.
Maybe.
That's pretty cool.
It looked really nice. All right. He'll be back soon.
This is my section of the podcast where I miss Dan.
Boy, people are passionate about their fucking superhero origin stories. We got a whole fucking Twitter full of future Batman directors here. They're all going to tell the fucking origin story.
We kicked the
Can't wait to see your movie, guys. It's going to be awesome. So I hate the good parts for Gus not being here.
What?
Me getting Chris in trouble? What?
Are you going to focus on that?
I feel so bad. I don't want Chris to get in trouble for something stupid I said.
It'll be fine. Don't worry about it.
But he's not really, though. He's getting in trouble for the thing he did.
It was my fault.
By the way, I had already forgotten about it, but thank you for reminding
me. Yeah, I presented that he could get the discount. I was like, you could get a discount from it.
Okay. So I mentioned that I got these earbuds.
What are those?
That amplify sound.
Yeah.
And Gus kept saying, bring them in. But Gus's ears are super gross. So I waited until he wasn't on the podcast.
Oh, so you've had them this whole time?
Well, I had them around, but I didn't want to bring them on. This is actually really cool. So these were sent to me because I talk about on the podcast. Oh, look at that. I talk about on the podcast. Hold on. Don't go anywhere. Look at this little case.
Ooh.
So you can't really see it too well.
That is a waste of space.
Look at that. See the light? So that is a charging case. These little earbuds that you put in here, they're like freestanding little earbuds. And then you put them in your ear. Wait, did I do the right one? Yeah. And then you put them in your ear. I won't do it on mine because I've seen it and you go with the experience. But then they amplify sound. Like you can turn the world up or down, basically.
So they're not for music?
No. I don't even think you could stream your like Bluetooth
really?
Through it.
So
yeah.
It's basically...
Somebody put them in. Yeah. So the right side goes on the right and the left side goes on the left.
They're basically what? Just ear... things. What are they called? Ear aids? Hearing aids?
Wait, this is the right...
No, yeah, so you go... Barb, let me see it.
Ear aids sounds like a really nasty disease.
No, just take this one, and it goes in just like this.
So would you want this built into your ear?
Just like that.
Yeah.
Okay.
I probably have a lot of earwax in my ears, though, too.
Toss them over.
I'm going to feel really bad if I...
That's the right one.
Oh, I almost went in my beer bottle.
Yeah, you can take that, Bart, and hit it, too.
It's the right one.
Here, and I'll get on my app, because then
You have to, like, really shove it in there.
It'll be fine. You'll have to turn it so it, like, goes into your ear. Can I see you? Yeah, that's it. Okay.
I can hear my. Like? I can hear my
put
own ear.
Put the other one.
Okay.
Can you hear it? Yeah.
That's actually
wait,
really
do
weird.
The other
bullshit.
One.
Bullshit.
Yeah. He was whispering.
Do the other one.
Okay. Are you gonna blast me with something?
No, I can't. Oh. It's. I actually wish it could go louder than it does. But because I talk about like goofy like new technology all the time on the podcast, they sent me a pair of these. So I'm gonna turn you up right now where you can hear more.
Damn it. I feel like Superman.
Yeah, you're crazy.
Oh, I am
right?
Well loud.
Yeah. And then
what
it's
do I
like,
sound like?
And now we can just turn down the world too.
Yeah. So like dick. The whispering is the weirdest bit.
Suck my dick, yeah.
It's like
Kev, suck my dick.
Somebody in the control room whisper something. We'll see if we can hear it.
Cunt.
Ready?
Hold on a second, Barb.
If somebody's in the control room is gonna whisper something, let's see if Gavin can hear it, but we can't. Go ahead.
Someone just said my name.
That wasn't
so,
super.
I heard that.
By the way, I want to point out that our control room, they didn't actually whisper. They made a whisper voice. They went this loud.
Gavin.
It was like they were whispering in like a Victorian play. I'm not sure what that was.
It seems like it doesn't amplify loud stuff as much as just very bottom of the line whisper stuff.
What is it?
Blaine. Okay. Oh, let me turn my thing on. So can you hear more?
Yeah. I mean, oh.
Blaine, you're a piece of shit.
Yeah, I hear a pretty fair amount.
You're a piece of shit. I fucking hate you.
I'm not a piece of shit. Don't hate me. I can't hear anything now.
I turn it down.
You're stupid. You're stupid.
So you can like tune out the world too.
Stupid.
And then
yeah,
this
is like count sound. Oh, that was sound canceling, and this is amplifying, I guess.
Yeah.
Whoa.
So can you hear that plane?
What is the damn plane?
We can all hear that plane.
Yeah, I hear everything. I can hear Lois.
And they're called Hear, H-E-R-E. And then, but I wish I could. They connected the Bluetooth from my phone. I wish I could stream music to them.
This is a really weird experience.
It feels like I'm right next to you, right?
It feels like a VR. I'm watching the RT podcast in a VR experience.
Why are you yelling?
That's really cool.
Huh? Am I yelling?
No, you're fine. But I really, one of the things I really like about the product too is that they
there's a case over there.
That case that they come in, you just plug the USB into the side of it and it charges inside the case.
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah.
How much were they, if you don't mind me asking?
I want to say they're like, I should look it up and say, because I did not pay for them. They were sent to me for free.
Are they here?
Full disclosure. I had Chris make a phone call, and they're going to be the new cast member for RT.
Oh,
please, please don't. Come on, man.
Hear earbuds.
It's a wait list for them. The,
yeah, they're, I think they're early. Prick. It's hearplus.me.
H-E-R-E.
H-E-R-E.
Join the wait list.
You can look up Hear Earbuds and find it too.
Hear Buds. Why aren't they called Hear Buds?
No, there you go. See? Should have been on the marketing team.
Little earaids.
So they had a Kickstarter, and now they're about to launch this product. So
not normal.
So would you buy them?
Oh,
what?
Oh, you mean actually spend money?
Well, you know, I always said. I mean, this is obviously like a high-end product, but I always said that if I had enough money, I would buy a set of night vision goggles.
Yeah,
and that's like this seems to me like this and night vision goggles, you'd be just like indestructible. You can see through like. Lead-based smoke. Anything, you know, you can navigate any environment.
I do this thing.
Can lead be smoke?
What?
Is lead light enough to be smoke?
I think it's just lead particles in it.
Yeah.
That, like, you know, whatevs.
Oh, a fly died in here.
I do this thing, and it kind of makes me a prick, but I have really good hearing.
You?
Yeah, me.
You have really, to.
I have good hearing, but I am very selective about what I hear. So
like
I can, I'll act like I can't hear somebody, even though I can hear them like super well.
Why?
Why? Yeah, what is that?
It can be advantageous. A, you could like tune someone out and just like, oh, he didn't hear me, you know, I guess I'll like bother him later about it. Or B, it's like if people are talking about you and they think they aren't being heard, but I can hear them. That's kind of a situation.
I watched you get mad at someone on set the other day. It was cool.
Who? And when?
What were they doing?
When the police car showed up.
Oh, yeah, that fucking guy.
Who is that?
I don't know. I was going to beat him to death. How was that shoot, by the way? Did you guys have fun?
The guy fucked with your shoot?
Oh, no. It was just a police car showed up during a shoot, and we were outside, and we were, like, really running against the clock. It was a 12-hour shoot, and we used every single minute of it. So we shot essentially three shorts. But basically, a cop pulled up, and he came out, and he had a red Solo cup. It was just from craft services. It wasn't anything, you know, bad. But it's a red Solo cup. You immediately associate that with a party or
that's
something.
That's a dumb. I get it, but yeah.
Yeah.
Am I dumb for this? Or
No. I mean, it's dumb that so the cop assumed there was something alcoholic in the cup?
Well, no. So the cop was there just talking to us because he wanted to know what was going on. I think somebody had filed like some sort of noise complaint. So he started walking and I was like, okay, this cop is already stopping me from shooting. If he questions this guy and then has probable cause to search the set.
It was just to avoid a line of questioning.
Then it's going to bring all these other things. And I was like, hey, you, can you step over there? Can you just like get rid of the cup? Get rid of the cup. And he was like, what? And he was like, I was like, get rid of the cup. And then he like walked to the cop with the cup. And I was like, motherfucker. Like my AD had to hold me back because I was like,
Was this an extra on set?
He's somebody else. I'll tell you about it later.
Okay.
Yeah. I don't want to sell anybody out.
Again.
Blaine is gun shy now.
I feel bad.
Blaine, we had a weird thing. I don't think we've ever talked about this. And correct me if I'm wrong if we have.
Uh-oh.
We had a shoot one time where it was one of Blaine's shoots. And we went 3/4 of the way through the day. And we had an actor there who was a day player that we hired. 3/4 of the way through the day, he decided he didn't want to be in it anymore.
Yeah, I think.
And he walked away.
Funhouse has talked about that publicly.
Yeah, I think we may have mentioned it.
We've talked about that.
Yeah, have we? Okay.
Yeah, that guy.
We never have run into anything like that in my life.
Well, you know the reason, right? Like, there was like a fart joke or something, and all of a sudden. Bruce had a fart joke.
And he was like, there was a scene with waterboarding, and he's like, he actually commented, he was like, hey, this script is great. Who wrote this? Did you write this? I was like, yeah, I wrote this. He's like, this is some funny shit, man. I was like, hey, thanks, dude. He's like starting to get on board because he'd been a hassle the whole day.
Yeah.
And then he got to a fart joke with Bruce and he was like, I'm a professional. This is stupid. And he left and I swore, I told everybody.
All right, let's drop it.
No. I want to make sure.
I went to his house.
I want to contact his
agent.
Agent his to make professional. Sure he never got work in this county.
His agent, I think, dropped him right after that.
He dropped him from Austin.
Well, we don't know that. We don't know anything about that.
Right.
We don't know anything about that. But that was weird. We never have had anything like that before.
Yeah.
We had something weird like that one time where Gavin, before he was an employee, was one time on Xbox Live with me where we wanted to put somebody in the Rooster Teeth comics where we drew their picture. And we just need to get a little that little permission slip filled out where it said, you have my permission to use my image.
Yeah, because Luke is drawing based on your likeness.
Yeah, we're drawing, we're saying it's you because you won this contest. We're doing it. And then they were like, they saw the form, which I get a lot of people get this way, where they're like, oh, well, I have to fill out a form? I don't know. This is like looks like a contract and everything. It's like, yeah, it just says we have permission. Just go ahead and read it or show it to somebody if you want to. We don't pressure people into it. But it lasted like 5 days. And it was like, the whole purpose of the contest is like way past what we thought. It was just like, and then he was like, well, I'm afraid that if I let you use my identity, I won't be able to use my identity any point in the future. It's like, what are you fucking talking about? It's
like, Rooster Teeth owns your face.
It was so weird. You're going to like publish an article about them, about every stupid mistake they've made or some shit.
I don't know.
Like
or like they wouldn't be able to use their own name and image in the future. Their own. Like,
someone Googles their name, it's the comic book character.
Just redirects to Rooster Teeth and that's it.
So is that why Nathan was always so tall that he couldn't see him in the frame of the comic book?
No, that was Nathan. He was in that.
I love
but then he that was funny though, because you were trying to do a nice thing for one of the fans, and then by the end of it, you were just like tearing your hair out. Like,
fuck that guy.
Well, he started to get. Then there was another guy who was like a pseudo lawyer who was helping him and advising him. I just ripped into that guy way more than the one.
What
dude.
Year is this?
It was Laird and Crows. It's fun to talk about now. I think it was Crows, and he was nervous about it, and that's a totally normal thing. But then Laird started like giving him legal counsel. I was like, what? It's like, what the fuck is this?
Remember that short where Carrie plays a lawyer and he's in his giant suit?
That might be one of my favorite characters in any Rushi short ever.
Carrie's lawyer?
Carrie is the lawyer. Yeah, that
Carrie
really,
in general in Archie law. Shorts is my favorite.
Like, I'll see you in court. I'll see you in hell. And then he just walks away.
He's so nice.
I like him in one of the new shorts coming up, too. He has a very brief cameo.
Oh,
have you seen that one?
I saw a cut of it, yep.
Yeah, okay. Is it one of the ones that I'm in?
Yes.
Okay.
Pretty funny.
That was fun. We had fun that day.
That was a good one.
So somebody asked you, why is Thor's hammer in front of me? Right here. You cut away just as I was pointing to it. So this is you can see it's engraved there. It's a Rooster Teeth on there. This thing is fucking heavy. So someone gave us.
Oh, watch your laptop.
I bet I can lift it.
There we go.
Do you think gravity would take it through the set?
See, and then on the back, it's got like the inscription, Thor's Mjolnir inscription.
I remember when you got that.
Pacific. It's Evan Gavin. Yo, even Gavin, sorry. I was reading the name. I thought the description at the bottom. It says, whosoever holds this hammer, if he be worthy, shall possess the power of Thor, even Gavin. So, I don't remember the name of the gentleman who gave it to me, but you can probably hear this as I set it down. Probably hear it.
His name's Evan Gavin.
It's pretty fucking solid. So, you want it over there?
But yeah, I kind of want to hold on to it now.
Set almost came down.
I think that's part of a barbell from, like weightlifting.
Yeah.
Yeah, because it has that, like, grip on it.
It's fun to mess with.
Do some reps while you do the podcast.
Do you think it would go through this table?
No, it's
you'll try.
No.
Well,
at the end, maybe.
Yeah, go for it. What the fuck?
You're kidding.
Move the beers. Move the beers.
You're fucking. No, move the beers. This is how I get fired.
No, but why? I'm telling you, do it.
That's a podcast set.
We're gonna be moving soon anyway.
Patrick's not here.
We will have to. We won't explain to Gavin or Gus how it happened.
Oh God!
Just say it.
He's
fell.
Probably watching right now.
I'm really scared.
Podcast. It just collapsed.
What's in there? Gotta get the beers off there, first of all.
I'm getting everything out of here, Bernie.
Just give it a solid, semi.
This is a bad idea.
Just use the weight of the thing.
This is
give
why
it to me, I'll do it.
You should watch the video version.
Give it to me, I'll do it.
Of the podcast.
No. Oh, God.
Right. Wait, we just want to see if it'll go through, right?
Oh, my God.
Wait, hold on. Wait. I want to get some slow-mo.
See if it'll go through.
Someone's
eyes are going to fuck.
Ready?
There's a fucking troll over here!
She's got a troll doll she just discovered. Oh. All right, you want to put the troll doll on the table?
All right, go for it.
All right, ready? Here we go.
Oh, God. Oh shit!
Yep. So, that might have, There we go. That's a good
idea. Right? Oh, my God! Burns!
No, it's fine. It'll still hold our beer. It's like a tripod now. That's a solid thing.
That was good.
That's good.
Was that the expected outcome of that, Bernie?
That was pretty solid.
Yeah.
You know? We could have auctioned off that table, I guess.
I saved it.
We're changing the podcast set eventually, right? Aren't we? Gus wanted to do it next week, but we can't.
Oh, you know what, though? The stakes won't be held up by this anymore.
It'll be
we'll
fine.
Have to put stakes on
the stakes have changed.
Somewhere out there, Marcus and Gus are like,
Barbara, how'd you miss that one?
What? I was too busy saving my drink from Gavin.
That was cool. That was really good.
Listen, you raised the stakes.
We might as well just destroy the thing at this point.
Yeah. It's okay. I'm sure Blaine knows a good guy we can call about a table discount for
Beef. Take that.
Fuck! Well, that was fun.
Is that what Chris was calling about earlier?
Yeah.
Was he freaking out?
Well, no, because he was calling because I sent an out-of-context text, and I was like, I am so sorry in advance. And he called, and I was like, I explained it to him, and he's like, you realize that was your idea? And I was like, oh, yeah, it was.
No, you
cut to tomorrow, and Chris is like a bag of his stuff at the door, and he's like, see,
slip
guys.
In hand. That's not funny.
So I'm going to buy a new table for 1 week, I bet.
Can I use that for Slimo, guys?
Yeah, sure.
It's cool.
You usually have like one piece of Rooster Teeth merchandise somewhere in there. This could be the.
What are we gonna do with this couch?
I want to give a big shout out. I'm sure it probably is on the podcast that we got this thing. It was after RTX, I think, like 2 years ago, and I don't remember the name of the gentleman who had this. But I thought about it the other day, and I was like, "Where is that hammer?" And I wrote to the everyone list about that, right? Like all hands of the company, and I was like, "I want to find this hammer that I had." And it turned out it was in somebody's office. They kept it for themselves.
Wasn't it in animation?
Machinima had it.
Oh.
Josh and Kyle had it. So.
Their new office is pretty dope.
Dude.
All the screens.
I think if I had seen that office, I should show you the picture from like where we did the first two seasons of Red versus Blue in my spare bedroom. And then like what they have now, which is essentially the Matrix.
They have what, 16 screens in there?
Dude, and they're all like
perfect
diagonal like to each other. Like it's
you have
beveled.
All the different controllers and Xboxes.
It looks like
down
someone
below.
Took the stamp tool in Photoshop.
It's pretty fucking cool.
They did a job did with it. That episode of $1 Million is out, right? Where Max is the control guy from NASA.
Yeah, that just came out.
That's that room. We use that, so like Max Kromke is the guy from NASA that contacts Burnie about lighting the rocket with his ass. And that's the room that we're talking about. Max is fucking funny.
He's great.
I'm sad the season's over for $1 Million, but
yeah,
it went
me too.
By really
yeah,
fast.
You know, it's
we still
done
have the
forever
bloopers
now.
Episode.
You know.
Done forever, don't say that. No, don't say that, because the audience takes that stuff really seriously.
Oh, shit. Okay.
Whenever you say that. So like, no, they're not going to make anymore. We're definitely going to make a season 3.
Yeah.
We've actually recorded a couple episodes already.
There's also something else that we started filming for, which should be really fun. It's very similar to $1 Million.
Are you talking about the shoot that we were on the other day?
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, I'm excited for that.
We're not ready to announce it, though, are we?
No.
I don't think so. Well, I'm going to be quiet.
It's just a live action thing.
Hey, you know, this is though the first time we've had the both of you on this podcast. Since the documentary with you guys came out.
Oh, yeah.
That's
where
true.
We took away your technology. We reset your technology to what it was.
Now you could say took away technology.
In the year of your birth. One of the original plans for it was I wanted to do one of you to the date of your birth and the other one to just 5 years ago. Just showing how much technology changed in just 5 years. Like, you couldn't have a smartphone. You know, you couldn't have like certain social media stuff.
Yeah but had, like, Twitter and smartphones were around 5 years ago.
They were. I mean, where we do 7 years, we'd have to find that sweet spot.
I would do it to 2007. Like the iPhone is the changing point for that.
iPhone would probably be a good one to do it to. Like they had to go back to like a Sidekick or something.
Or even
like
just
that.
Like the beginning of the internet.
Yeah.
Like what was that? 95, 97?
Yeah, you guys were like 89 though.
I was 89. Yeah, he was 90.
I was 90. I think we just went back to 89 for
me. Man, the one thing that was just too much production value and not enough time to make it, and we were trying to find a specialty person to create it, was, you know, all the stuff that we have now is very stream of consciousness, very in the moment, very live, and the only equivalent for something that was live back then was even the stock market was delayed like 15 minutes, and the only way you get live information was you thought from TV, but that was delayed 15, 20 minutes.
Binoculars.
Those dudes who had those, like, the glass dome with the ticker tape, and they would sit there and read that.
Uh-huh.
Like, that was the most up-to-date information about stocks. So I was trying to find one of those old ticker tape machines, but that would print your Twitter feed all the time. Like, nonstop. And you would just sit there and read your Twitter feed on this ticker tape.
Man, you guys could have pranked me really hard with that.
I would
like,
buy that
Barbara
device.
Over and over.
It'd probably be really expensive, but it'd be funny to have that, right?
Would be really funny.
What were you saying? I'm sorry.
I said it'd be funny to prank me with that. Because then you could just tell people to write these really long tweets to me or like tweet me over and over and over or tweet me the same word over and over. And like,
they handed out our beeper number.
It would
so
just
we were
be sitting there.
I didn't get my beeper number handed out.
Oh, I mean, not to like the general audience, but like employees were beeping us and then our email. Or it wasn't our email.
Yeah, Gus.
Our phone numbers, our home phones.
Gus and Bethany left me, I want to say 4 messages of them just playing songs from 1989 on my answering machine.
Yeah.
I don't know if any of that ended up in the documentary, but that happened.
They sent that to me, too. Yeah.
All right, we need a story about what happened at the table. We got to get our story straight here. What happened at the table?
It was filmed live.
That's fine. We can cut that out.
There was
There's only sponsors. Sponsors have our backs.
There was a bird that flew into the studio.
They won't tell us.
Just say one of the lights fell down.
It was dying, and you went to go save it.
Fell down. Yeah, the grid collapsed, and it killed three people and also cracked the corner of the table. All right, we'll get it figured out.
I'll take the blame if you let Chris free.
What's that? Will you?
Yeah. I'll pay for the table.
Let me think about this.
I like that we're like trading blame as like currency now.
Yeah. it's a trading responsibility.
I'll buy a new table if Chris has no repercussions for the wrongful story that I told. It was my fault.
About him trying to get a discount on a private service for...
I'm pretty sure it was like I said. I was like, you could probably get a discount from it too.
Next week, should we put a piece of cardboard with a table drawn on it over here and see if Gus notices?
Surely it would cost more because you're using it as a filming location.
Well, it would promote
We got discounts for doing parachuting because it was like, oh yeah, you're basically promoting us.
Yeah. Well, it was also like how we filmed at that place, Texas Ski Ranch, for immersion.
Yeah. It's like free advertisement for them.
Yeah.
God, can I send you guys a picture in there? Can you guys put up a picture if I send it?
Yeah.
Okay. There's an address for that to go to, right? Don't say it out loud.
Also, was that the same troll that was in
the controller? Hey, just do this. If one of you guys can, there's a tweet. There's a tweet to me that just came in. It's from Hold That Ghost. It's a great name. But it shows Jeff in front of the RVB setup from a few years ago.
Did you decorate that room?
Hey, what?
Did you decorate it or try and keep it nice like a guest bedroom? Did you put up like nerd stuff on the walls?
Oh yeah, we had like Tron posters.
Oh cool.
That one Tron poster I have, and then I think a Reservoir Dogs poster. It's like
sounds like the 80s.
Yeah.
Did you ever have a bed in there?
No, we had a couch bed in that room.
Oh okay. 90s.
So I mean we hadn't yet bought all the furniture in the house when I started RVB there. We did paint it green though one day for some
reason.
What
was the first purchase? So say you already had an Xbox. I assume did you just bring over each other's Xboxes, or did you actually go out and buy more?
We had to start Red versus Blue. I had to buy an extra controller, and instead of borrowing Gus's copy of Halo, I just bought another copy of Halo. So our production budget to start Red versus Blue was $110.
Was that for episode one, or was that like episode three or four or something?
That was like three or four, yeah.
Nice.
So as far as like budget to like the, you know, box office or whatever you want to call Red versus Blue, like the revenue from the show, it's got to be like one of the heaviest hitters.
That's
ever.
A great ratio.
Yeah. Huh. It's like $100 to a show that's lasted now for going into its 14th season.
I heard Rodriguez is trying to shoot something like a feature on like a $5,000 budget or something. Like
really?
That. Yeah.
Isn't that what he did when he started off?
Back to his roots.
Yeah. But it's like, I mean, he's like calling in favors like from like professional dudes that are in the industry, but it's like,
yeah. His new budget. The thing is, though, he can call people like, you know, anybody I know would be in Robert Rodriguez's $7,000 feature, right? You know, yeah. It's like, yeah. He'll be able to get, like, you know, the people he usually puts in his movie. Like, William Valderrama, I'm sure, will just go, yeah, sure, I'll come do your $7,000 movie. What the fuck? Hey, careful.
I was watching
that.
What? Yeah, so that is our second setup.
What have you got on that, Amiibos? What is that on the top of that?
Oh, no, there's a Homestar Runner figurine.
They do look like Amiibos.
And then there's a pink donut. Somebody painted a Joyride Master Chief photo. Look how, like... The weight of that desk is like, oh, the monitors are leaning
in. Bowing the desk.
Because there's those big CRTs on top of two massive Xboxes.
Look at those wires.
Yeah, they were wired controllers back then. So we had to like...
It's a nightmare.
And what Jeff is crying about there is we would like pick up the controllers and then set them down. But after doing that for a course of a day, you wouldn't set them back down in the same orientation. So you'd be like winding them up. And we'd have this big rat's nest like right in the middle of the whole thing.
Also, setting controllers down, deadly.
Awful.
You gotta be so careful you don't put it on the left trigger because a grenade will end up in the middle of your
Jason
shot.
Was the worst about that.
Yeah. I was pretty bad about
it. He would
too.
Chuck grenades all the time.
Oh, this is the new setup. Machinima room.
Look at it.
Oh, yeah, that's the new Machinima room.
So pretty.
That's like walls of flat panel
Is that
monitors.
For show or is every screen an actual used
Also,
screen?
I think that's
Everyone
before...
Everyone is just doing stuff on PC.
That's before they had it finally set up, I believe, because the computers aren't in there yet.
That looks cool.
Yeah, it's pretty smooth.
That looks cooler than the set of The Matrix.
Really?
Yeah. And then everything was so different back then because we had to do that. So that all that was definitely pre-YouTube. So we would have to take our own file, encode it six different ways. That was like a whole day of the production. I had to encode high res and low res for QuickTime, high-res and low-res for WMV, and high-res and low-res for DivX, and then post them all. And we had to host them all ourselves.
And sometimes BitTorrent.
And sometimes BitTorrent, yep. Speaking of hosting things yourself, this episode of the Rooster Teeth Podcast is also brought to you by Squarespace. When we were starting Red versus Blue, the biggest thing, the biggest problem we had was when we had a viral hit, like the first episode, first few episodes of Red versus Blue, when they just took off, there was this idea that if you had a big hit, that the ad truck was just going to show up at your back door and just start dumping money on you. But it was exact opposite. We had to pay for everyone to be downloading all of these things, and there was no video ad environment. Like, there was no YouTube, so there were no pre-roll ads. Those things didn't exist. So we had to start doing...
browser.
Yeah, so we had to start supporting our business with t-shirts and subscriptions. That was the first thing that we did in the sponsorship model. And I can guarantee we would not have been able to do those things if we hadn't been on our own .com site. It just wouldn't... This wouldn't be the same Rooster Teeth it is today if not for those things. And so with Squarespace, you can do that same kind of thing with sites that look professionally designed. Regardless of your skill level, there's no coding required. They offer intuitive and easy-to-use tools to help you along the way. And you get a free domain name if you sign up for a year. Start your free trial site today at squarespace.com/roosterteeth. When you decide to sign up for Squarespace, make sure you use the offer code roosterteeth. That's roosterteeth to get 10% off your first purchase. Squarespace, build it beautiful. Squarespace has been a very long time sponsor of the podcast. And I
feel like they were one of the first.
I know. And I love when people always tweet at me and say, like, I started my taking your advice, starting my own corner of the web. This is my destination and doing it. I love to hear that because that's great.
I still remember when it was redversusblue.com and not roosterteeth.com.
Yeah.
It took me forever to break the habit of going to redversusblue.com.
I also just whenever I refer to it, I would say redversusblue.com. To redversusblue.com.
I assume it forwards now.
You know like how you have those like URLs like implanted in your memory that you can just do them like a bajillion minutes or words per second?
Well, this time you just have to type in usually the first letter. Like F, Facebook, G, Google, R, Rooster Teeth. Or Reddit sometimes.
Yeah, Red versus Blue has been my first bookmark for like 14 years now.
Wow, that's crazy.
And like as you move on, because all those bookmarks are in the cloud now, it's just carried on the whole time. Mm-hmm. So the Rooster Teeth, I guess it's still Red versus Blue that redirects, but it's been there for like over a decade.
That's I remember when I used to get a new phone, I'd have to like re-enter all my contacts in. Like every time. I haven't done that in probably 8 years.
Sometimes I wish that I would have to though, because I've been through my phone and it's just been like tons of names that I was like, I don't know who any of these people are.
Yeah. Really?
Wow. When was the last time you went through your phone and you were just like, yeah, I know all these people.
I went through on a 3-hour flight where I didn't have anything to entertain myself with. So I went through my contacts and I deleted the ones I don't talk to anymore.
I need a purge again.
But it took almost the whole three hours.
People. Like my messages app is just full of numbers and like rarely there's one that's actually a contact. I just never add people.
So in Xbox, you have this thing where you can set your favorites.
You're a real person.
Yay.
You can set your favorites on Xbox. Like you can do it on iPhone too. There's lots of services where they let you set a favorite list of contacts.
I have one.
But all I care. What's your favorite on Xbox?
On my phone, I have one.
Yeah, Meg.
Yeah.
Oh, that's so sweet. Good. I'm sure your mom will be happy to hear that.
Luke's at the bottom there.
Hey, Aaron Marquis.
Oh no, wait, second to bottom.
Yeah, I'm right below. Now, why does your mom have a photo and nobody else does?
I don't know.
I'm super anal about that. I have to put photos with all my contacts.
What's my photo on your phone?
I don't know. I think it's your old Twitter avatar or like that. You have this one headshot, Gavin. I don't know how else to describe it. It's like your smoky one where you're like all like.
I don't know which one are you
it's
talking
like
about.
Like fucking Better Minds going or something in it.
Your Smokey the Bear one, you know.
Siri.
Wow. Can find it. Got a lot of technology over here. Got an iPad, iPhone, and iMac. What are you going to do? Go fuck yourself, Gavin.
Okay, explain what you just did to a caveman.
Oh, by the way, that is the best feature of the Apple Watch by far.
Why can't you do it from a laptop?
I don't know. Like, I can do this, and it makes my phone ping wherever it is in the world.
All right, well, explain it.
Bluetooth range.
To a caveman.
I can't.
What you just did.
That's impossible.
I don't know. My talking device.
What is that?
I can't find my thing that allows me to talk to people. So I have to use something that's on my hand that tells me where the sun is. And then when I talk to it in a certain way, it tells me where the talking device is.
I have this one for Gavin for some reason.
That's yours?
Yeah, you probably can't see that on the monitor, but that's the one for
it's
some
like
reason.
10 years ago.
No, mine for you is your, it's your Rooster Teeth portrait. I don't know if you guys can see that. You guys see that?
Names of my family
you guys,
members.
If you guys have watched videos from Rooster Teeth, we have portraits in the front hallway. This is Gavin's. It's always made me laugh. That's by Mental Fusion does that.
That's taken from a picture of me wearing broken sunglasses. Have you ever seen that one where I've just got like one side of the sunglasses in?
Oh, is that what it's from?
Yeah, and yeah. I'm drinking a Guinness. It's from that.
Yeah, but I have to put them in for everybody. It drives me crazy. I'll put them in for like companies, like American Airlines, that message me. I hate getting a text and I don't know who it's from.
What's mine?
Now oh God, are we gonna go through this?
It's a dick pic.
Yeah, I wish.
It's a bicep.
Now I want to know what mine is.
Gavin sent me this thing. I don't even remember. I don't even remember recording. It was on his phone.
Oh,
he had laser team. Yeah.
How can we play that?
It's I don't really know. We funny. Can find a way.
You can send.
Blaine, I haven't texted you in a long time.
Nudes? Question mark.
Blaine.
It's a peck.
I hardly have photos for anybody. Now I'm really sad.
No, I think it's just Twitter avatar too.
Oh, okay.
I mean, I go for whatever is the easiest thing. Although the first picture that I have in like the thing, that's Twitter avatar.
Oh no, I hate that picture.
That was from
I just look people up on Google and then like grab the first one.
Okay.
But then it's weird because in order to put it in my contacts, I have to save it to my image gallery first. So occasionally when I go through like a run of those, I'm like, I can't stand how many blank names I have in my text messaging.
You just have pictures of all these
All of a sudden I have like all these like random photos of people like headshots.
You know you can
like
auto
that.
Pull from Facebook.
Say that. Again?
It can just look through Facebook and take auto all those pull. Profile pictures.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Yeah,
I would love to
just,
know.
It just links it.
I have pictures of mine. I didn't set any of them.
If
it's just
you've
Facebook.
Linked your phone number with Facebook and your friend has linked their phone number with Facebook and you have each other in your contacts, it'll pull their Facebook picture.
But
as
the
their phone. But you have to have that set up.
The downside to that though is whenever you have like the you know the, like when the Paris attacks happened or like the everybody's doing the red
oh,
and white
yeah.
equality signs. It's like you have 14 people that are like. The equality flag thing.
Yeah.
And you're like, damn it, who are
yeah,
you?
I guess it does update
yeah,
it.
Fuck off equality. Who needs you?
And then all of the
I'm
people
helping.
Who don't have that are like scummy people, I guess.
God, everybody Becca wants to know what hers is now too. Fuck off, everybody. I love you.
No, but fuck off.
Siri learned all the emojis. Just so me. I'll be like, call mom. And then that's my mom's thing. It's Leah Gibson and then a little elephant emoji. And then mom, because I like elephants and my feel like associate with it.
Did you know?
Hey,
he's
in the middle of the story.
A story.
No, it's funny.
You're a piece
he's literally
of shit.
Saying something.
So, and I'll say, like, hey, Siri, call. I don't even
hey,
want to finish the story.
That?
I say, call mom. And it'll be like, calling Leah Gibson, elephant emoji, mom. And I was like, no, Siri.
This is elephant emoji.
I never put emojis in people's names.
Well,
like, I don't
so
get that, like,
poop
adding
emoji?
A heart.
Ooh. Oh, hold on.
So, say poop? A long time ago, I put Barb's name in my phone as Burp Burp Dunkin' Snack. And then I was like, I would type it wrong and type it as Barb. And I go, oh, no, it's a Burp Burp Dunkin' Snack. And I would type that. And then I changed it. Finally, I said, what am I doing with this? It's like a 3-year-old joke. So I changed it to Barbara Dunkelman.
No.
Why?
But now I can't. I had to change it back because I kept typing it as, I'm like, Burp Burp. Am I not spelling Burp Burp right? I was like, oh, wait, that's right. It's Barbara now.
My favorite story is when you had Bluetooth on your truck and you said you tried to call me one time and you had to go, call Burp Burp Dunkin' Snack. And she goes, calling Burp Burp Dunkin' Snack.
You can do it right now. So here's the crazy thing. I was complaining about my watch. I was complaining about my phone. I spent a whole day trying to reset my watch, reset my phone, do all that stuff. It still didn't work. You asked me on that podcast, what version of the OS do you have? And I said, I have the most recent one. While we were on the podcast, they put a new version of the new update for the OS out, fixed all my problems with my iPhone.
Really?
Literally every single problem I've been having, it fixed every last one of them.
Mine, Steve Jobs is listening.
Mine is like...
But thank you for everyone who tweeted at me trying to solve my problem. I really appreciate it.
I smashed mine recently, so this is brand new. Brand new replacement phone.
You How better long? Clarify. You haven't smashed it since the last time you told us you smashed
yeah,
it.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
I haven't smashed it again. But this one gets
put
really,
on the table.
Really
get the hammer.
This one gets hot and it dies within 2 hours.
Sorry.
So I have to do. I'm refusing to do it, but I have to do the thing where I just start a new phone and I don't use a backup. But then I'll lose all my crap.
You
or
have a lot of crap.
You and I could do this together. The Galaxy Samsung 7, right, was now said called the most advanced smartphone, best smartphone ever rated by. Consumer electronics.
Until the next iPhone comes out.
Maybe so. The next iPhone for sure is going to be underwater proof.
Call Barbara.
Or just waterproof. However you want to say that.
The next iPhone is going to have two lenses, supposedly.
Calling Barbara smiling pile of poo.
Pile of poo.
This is how short my attention span is. You did that and I was like, oh, someone's calling me.
Oh. Technology.
Technology.
Bad.
It's great.
Call Burp Burp Dunkin' Snack.
Calling calling Barber Duncan Snack.
It's been there. It's been like that forever. I'm sorry, Barber. I'm calling you here.
So I noticed when I was doing Miss a tweet Sprinkle. Once that the flags in the emoji keyboard, they're two characters. What's that about?
What?
Huh?
Yeah.
Oh, like CA or something?
No, like you do like British flag in a tweet and you have 138 characters left.
Oh, I see what you're saying. Oh, it's probably just like a hex code or some kind.
Yeah, it's something to do with the coding of it.
Because I don't know. So you're saying whenever you put an emoji in something that counts as two characters?
No, just the flags. All the other emojis are one character.
Yeah. Oh. I don't know.
I think it's because it's the country code.
I'm not sure. I don't understand emojis. Like, I don't know who owns them. Like, somebody drew those emojis.
Back in the day, that was an app that you downloaded, and then you go to your keyboard, and it's like, allow emoji in your international keyboard thing.
I have tried to get other keyboards, and the notifications or warnings that come up before you install that always scare the shit out of me. Basically, it's like, the maker of this app will be able to see everything you type, potentially.
Oh, because it has to be put into every app.
Yeah.
And into the core.
Right.
That's horrifying.
And you're updating your keyboard so they can just capture the data, anything that you type on your phone.
That's really fucked up.
I would not, I don't want that.
Fucking Snapchat, man.
Of course, then, you know, you're just jumping on Snapchat. Snapchat keeps all that stuff, too.
They've got a lot on
there. They say they delete that stuff. They don't.
Nope.
They went to court one time. They were subpoenaed. They pulled out something that was like
they said there was
old.
Some penis.
They pulled something out. Like, judge said, let's see some penis. They said, we have it right here.
Oh, goodness.
Yeah,
I actually have started using Snapchat.
Who what?
I've started using Snapchat.
How do you like Snapchat?
I'm getting used to it. I never thought I'd say that in my entire life. But I get it. I get why people like it so much. It's fast.
So what stuff do you do that you don't do on like Twat or Vine?
I just look at people's stories. You know, it's nice seeing like pictures and videos without having to read anything.
Mine is purely for voyeuristic reasons. I don't do anything that sends that out to people. I just
watch
people's
Snapchat?
Stories. Yeah.
I'm at you.
Just don't tell me, don't say what my name is because I went public with my name once. I was like, yeah, this would be fun. Get some boob pictures. And then I just got like tons of pictures of like 12-year-old kids, just boys. And I was like, I don't want this. And they'd
be like saying hi to you?
In class. And I'd be like, I don't fucking care about this. And yeah, it was just like, it's little kids. And I was like, I don't want this.
Actually,
how can they send
you
stuff without you?
Like
Twitter where they put an at?
I must have fucked up or something. Yeah, I guess they...
Well, you can follow people and you only see their stories if you want.
But, yeah, but like...
The other
if I'm getting blown up, it's like, you have a new message from so-and-so, then I have to check
no,
it.
No, I turned off that...
Really?
What if it's boobs?
I turned
off
that people who aren't my friends cannot send me snaps. So I don't even get alerts.
Apparently,
so
Blaine
I can
is
see...
following a lot of 12-year-old boys, apparently.
Probably just has that turned on. You just have to go into
I think originally I was like, accept all, probably.
Yeah.
Who is the coolest 12-year-old
boy? Blaine's gonna need a discount at the bail bondsman. Here,
God damn it! No,
if you know a good lawyer,
Chris,
we'll put him in an RT life.
This is the worst.
RT death. Ripping.
I don't want to watch someone's eye surgery. I'm not into that.
No, why would you? Yeah. Why what prompted
it's
that?
Because
an hour
I needed RT recap ideas.
Nobody wants to do that. Yeah.
What prompted that?
Yeah, I'm sorry. I was like wondering why you were talking, getting back to the eye surgery thing. I had forgotten by this point in the joke. That it was Chris was asking for free eye surgery. Or discounted eye surgery.
It was
if
Blaine.
If you're getting discounted, it shouldn't be eye surgery. Just pay full price for that.
You want the full rate. You want full attention from the surgeon.
You do. That's you don't want to go for the like the lowest bidder.
Would you ever get plastic surgery?
Sure. I would I haven't, but I would.
But
let me think.
What would you do? What's imperfect on your body that you
don't
need plastic surgery?
I don't know. I'm not really upset about anything. I mean I think about like teeth whitening and stuff. I've done that previously.
How did you do that?
I went tanning. Ashley made me go tanning before we went on the Amazing Race.
Oh,
she
really?
Did. It was part of the thing where it's like, but you know,
real tanning or spray?
Was that? Oh yeah, real tanning.
Like in a bed?
Real tanning under a bulb. Yeah. So yeah, no, we went to some place that she knows.
Darkutan.
I think it might have been Darkutan. I think it might have been. It's right in the same complex as the gym.
Oh yeah, at Palm Beach.
Palm Beach. That's it. Okay. That's where we went. And so. And I felt like I had this, I was like so self-conscious being in there. I kept explaining to the receptionist why I was coming, you know? So I just sounded like this guy who's like kept yakking about his TV show that he was going to be on. So I just came across as a bigger asshole. But I just felt so self-conscious about being in a tanning place.
Did you feel weird lying naked on like a plastic bed?
No, my bed at home is plastic.
Did you get the little gross. Did you get the little eye thingies that they stick on you?
Yeah. I was actually worried because I felt like they lit up and I thought they're not blocking enough Like, I want the Batman. I want the lead-based ones when I'm in there. I don't want to burn my... Because you're staring into those...
Yeah, it can cause serious eye damage.
I only went three times, so it's like I couldn't even really do much damage. Yeah, but
you went three times?
I'm glad I did it.
It's to protect your eyes. The UV...
Is that a lot, the way you said it?
Yeah.
Is three times a lot?
I thought you just went once. Like,
that once wouldn't do shit.
No, once is if you're going to get the spray thing. And one time, I went to a spray place... I went with my ex, and as a joke, I said, I'll do it. I turned it all the way up, because I thought it'd be funny. And anyway, I went to that one premiere at the Alamo, and I was like, orange.
it's like that scene in Friends.
Yeah, because he gets darker as time goes on.
Yeah, I thought it would be so funny, and it wasn't funny.
Speaking of tanning, bought a hammock at the weekend for my back garden, right?
Gavin just contacted me. He wanted to know, how do I buy a hammock?
I just couldn't find where to buy a hammock.
Amazon.
I wanted to go buy one that day.
Do you have the place I told you to go?
No.
Where'd you go?
I went to Home Depot and I bought the cheapest hammock.
Yeah, Home Depot.
Did you get one with a stand? Or do you get one where you had to put
a stand? It's like a big sort of like, it's like a bent staple. And put it out. Was lying in it for a bit. I was like, this is top, lying in the sun.
It's good.
Went in to get a drink, came back, bird shit on it.
That happens.
Did you clean it off?
Nah.
What do you mean? You laid down in bird shit?
No, I just haven't used it again since. I got to clean it.
So now you have to throw it away.
Yeah, no, because I got one more use out of it. Flip it over. Lie on that side until a bird shits on it, and then I'll just bung it in the wash.
Well, here's another great idea.
What?
Wipe off the bird shit. How about you just do that? Don't be a fucking animal.
Yeah, why don't you just go get a wet rag?
I just didn't feel like gagging at the weekend.
Oh, you're the worst. Where did shit? Like, towards the top or the bottom? You can always, like, flip yourself, too.
You know, it's good luck if a bird shits on you. Side.
Yeah, I mean, it's not ideal.
It's good luck.
Hammocks are great, dude.
Yeah, I liked it, yeah. Briefly.
Hammocks are really great. What are we going to do with the nose stuff when they move? Are they taking that with them?
I assume they're taking it with them.
Yeah, the No is going into a new...
With the bunk beds?
They're going to the old Achievement Hunter office.
Yeah.
Oh, man. You could use one of those in stage two. I sleep in the big bunk beds a lot.
Yeah.
I don't think those things have ever been washed. I've slept in those bunk beds. I would say I've slept like 8 nights in those bunk beds.
Good Lord, really?
I don't think that they've ever been washed. Yeah, man. Season one of $1 Million Butt was a...
I'm going to tell an anonymous story.
Why don't you just work from home?
You're going to tell an anonymous
story? I'm going to protect the identity of the subject of the story.
I wish I'd done that earlier.
Hey, I wish you had, too. Everyone wishes you had.
Fucking shit.
Have we ever told the story about the person who came to work here, and like the first week they came to work here, they got bed bugs? Have we ever talked about that?
Continue, because it was not me. So that's
no, it was somebody who came to work here, and they got... Turned out they had their apartment where they lived, got bed bugs, and they got evicted from it.
Is this person still here?
Well, we're not going to say any details because they may or may not be still here.
Yeah.
But it was interesting because this person has had a very storied career at Rooster Teeth. Integral part of the team. But there was a discussion in that first week of, do we really want this person to work here? Because, like, we were all worried about getting bed bugs.
Yeah.
Because it was like a big scare at the time. Like,
can bed bugs sit on people?
They just slide off like a what? Hey, you don't get to do that. There's a microphone right in front of your face, you dumbass.
He's like, tell me who it is.
You're whispering into your mic.
Tell me.
I was.
Here, do you want
the people can still hear things like
earbuds?
People can still hear the slop of your mouth.
Slop.
What's that, Gavin?
So, but they can't. They just go in sheets and beds.
Yes.
They don't go on. Person.
No, they can go clothes and stuff like that. No, it's terrible. Like, if you go to a hotel and you put your suitcase down, for instance, in a hotel that has bed bugs, just...
You're done.
Leave it at the airport, basically.
A lot of apartments are really serious about bed bugs, too. Like, they'll evict you.
New York City hotels.
Yeah. Are they microscopic or you can see them?
You can see them.
You can see them.
How big are they?
They are... You know what a carpenter ant is?
No.
That big?
Okay. They're just kind of a big bug.
I used to live in a co-op, and co-ops are filled with, like, really gross people.
They're smaller than a penny. Smaller than a dime.
Very small. But we had bed bug problems at the co-op a whole lot.
What's something smaller than that?
Anyways, a lady that got bed bugs, and she was this crazy lady. I think she was, like, 50-something. And the thing with co-ops is, as long as you're a student or a staff or a faculty member, you can live in the co-op. Well, she was, like, a faculty member at some, like, community college. So she found some loophole that she was able to... Anyways, nobody liked her. She was crazy. She got bed bugs. So she thought, instead of contacting the people that would get rid of them, since it was a common problem, she took her bed sheets and she put them into her car, assuming that the heat would kill the bed bugs.
Oh my
God. And then her car got bed bugs.
Oh, my God. Really?
Dumb person.
That's how they treat them a lot.
But
they just steam the bed?
No, they just raise the temperature to like 130 degrees in your house. Like, they superheat your house.
And it kills them.
And just it'll damage a load of your stuff.
And it'll kill them. Well, not 130 degrees. Like, 200 degrees might. But, like, 130 degrees is, like, 10 degrees hotter than a super, super hot day. Or maybe 15 degrees hotter than a super, super hot day.
In Austin.
In Austin. Again, like fucking Michigan. But then again, who gives a shit about Michigan?
Oh, so
what
I
was
care,
what
I
was
care.
Your issue with him having?
It was just it was a concern. It was a concern
because you didn't want him to hop onto you.
Yes, exactly. We didn't want to like go home and all of us get bed bugs in our house because someone was coming to the office on a regular basis with bed bugs.
So how is this problem solved?
We just like a lot of things. We just forgot about it after like 6 hours of debate. And then we're
little do we know, Rooster Teeth is covered in bed bugs.
What's that?
Got bed bugs everywhere.
That's actually.
I'm also fairly certain I found a bed bug in the office.
When?
Where?
Not here. Oh. Look, see, now you're worried. Yeah. Now that it's your problem, now you're all fucking worried. No, it was at the Congress office. I thought I saw a bed bug in the couch.
That's crazy though. A bed bug almost changed history for Rooster Teeth.
It would have.
Like he's big deal at Rooster Teeth.
Very big deal at Rooster Teeth. Very big deal at Rooster Teeth. And you now we know it's a heat, so. What? Narrowed it down. Good old bed bug. Stop it. Hey, did you guys hear the thing that the, I want to make sure I get the name of the stupid town right. Did you hear about the police department that tweeted out, or she didn't tweet out, they put it on Facebook. They posted that they had recently discovered that meth and I think crack found in their community had been laced with Ebola, the Ebola virus.
Holy
shit.
So
if you have crack or meth, you should bring it in the station to be tested for Ebola. And a woman brought in her meth to be tested for Ebola, and they arrested her. And it went viral and got this national news and everything. And everybody reported on it. And everybody's like, that's entrapment.
That's entrapment.
You're like, that you're doing this. And like they posted the lady, and they were making a big deal about it on Facebook. To me... okay, the entrapment, the law enforcement via social media, these are all terrible things. It's way worse for the police department to be saying Ebola is in our community.
Yeah
and, like public panic.
And a small portion of the population could be unknowingly infected with Ebola. So anyway, har, you know, and they're playing this, like, they posted like this meme. It's actually really a town really close to Austin. I think it's Granite Shoals.
I can't believe that they did that.
Can't believe that lady fell for it.
I love picturing her going in there and them checking it out, and they're like, all right, there's no bowl in here. She's like, cool, so I can get that back. Just get out of here. Like, what are you expecting?
Wait, but was the purpose of posting that to, like, catch people with meth and crack, or was there actually tests?
It was for love.
Dude, it seemed like such an encapsulated experience of being on the web for this police department, because they posted this joke post.
So it was a joke.
Then they got kind of a viral hit from it because the woman came in and then like people were reporting on it. And then they were like, if you want more information about our crazy news story, talk to this person in the press department. They'll talk to you all about it. And they did a couple follow-up posts and stuff like that. And then they started to get backlash on it like really quickly. And people going, you know, there's a lot of people who are like, why are you guys wasting time with a single drug user? You know, and all this stuff. Why aren't you finding it? Then there was that whole crowd. But then there were the people like, you can't do this. You can't just like entrap someone. Someone else made a really great point, which is there are times when this will happen where a drug supply is tainted and they actually do need to inform people that it's tainted. And that's valuable information. I mean, I don't know how you feel about drug use, but you probably don't want the people dying of fucking rat poisoning, you know, or something like that. Look at Blaine's like, I'm not sure, maybe.
I don't know, cracking mouth.
No, but you need to inform them. In that case, it's a public health issue. It's not, at that point, really a criminal issue, except for the person who's poisoning it. So you got to let them know that. Or in the case of a fucking Ebola, when you notify everyone in your community that Ebola is now in your community,
you
should be aware of it. Ebola in Clarksville.
Just kidding. It's another meth lab.
Yeah, but it says, a joking Facebook post warning heroin, and meth users of Ebola in their supply netted a Texas police department one arrest and a social media outcry. Police in Granite Shoals, about 55 miles northeast of Austin, I believe it's northwest, shared a fake breaking news alert picture Tuesday night claiming the drugs could be contaminated with the life-threatening disease Ebola. And then the weird part about it was, then the police department got super defensive, and their post that they put up in defense of telling everyone in their community that they are exposed to Ebola, they did this post that talked about how tough it is to be a cop, and a lot of them have PTSD, and it's like they need to be able to joke around, and like also a lot of cops get shot too. It was like this big dramatic like post. It was like, What do you do? What is this, like, total misdirect of people just upset with you because you're not doing your job and you're like, you're pulling out all these like heartstring things. It's crazy. They compare themselves like to Iraq war veterans.
Oh, really?
Stuff like that. It was really just a bizarre show for the Granite Shoals Police Department on social media.
There are some jobs where you just joking shouldn't be a part of it. And that's something I've noticed here a lot.
That would be one of them.
Yeah. Something I've noticed here a lot in the US is that people damn love making jokes. Like when Tony was in the hospital a few months ago and like the nurse who was like hooking up to the stuff was like cracking jokes left and right. And I was like, yeah, we get it. You're like the funny guy. Let's be
Maybe
serious about this.
Fucking rope that in.
I was like, we were asking questions. He would just crack a joke back. It's like, yeah, but I actually want to know the answer to the question I asked.
Oh.
Yeah, I had that. Yeah. There was that RTA where
Patch Adams.
I had that like panic attack, and I thought I was having some kind of heart issue.
Yeah.
And they tested my blood and saw my potassium was like a touch low, so they were going to give me a potassium supplement. And she brought it in and gave it to me, and I was like, wow, this is crazy. She goes, yeah, I have to sit here and watch you take it. And I said, you have to watch me take it? She goes, yeah, we can't just give potassium to just anybody. I have to watch you. And I took the pill and I swallowed it with water. I go, why is it like illegal or something? Or it's like people sell them? And she goes, no. That's potassium. It affects your heart rate. And so if you ever hear like a nurse killing her patients, that's what they give them. And then she took the glass of water from me and walked out of the room. And I was like, the fuck was that? And I was just sitting there. I was already like in an anxiety situation. And I was like, did she just joke about killing me? Based on what she gave me to take?
Were you like, that's what, bananas?
How did you get that settled? Like, did she come back and you're like, wait?
Yeah.
What was that?
No, I guess I was just fine. Like, I don't even know that I saw that nurse again. Are you booing Barbara's banana pun? Yeah. You guys were slow on the uptake.
Thanks for holding the camera on me for that whole time, too.
Because I feel like in their head, they treat it like a scene from a movie where they like crack the joke and walk out of the room, and that's the end of the scene. But in real life, you're like, no, wait a second, huh? And then you just like follow them out, and they're like, "What do you mean?"
Oh, Grant Scholes has deleted everything associated with this now.
I had a doctor, and I couldn't tell if he was joking or if he just like legitimately meant it. But I was like, probably like 11 or 12, getting a physical because I was going to be doing like football or basketball or something. And you had to get physicals, and he's like, "All right, you're checking out. If you just drop your pants for me, I have to see down there. I know this is embarrassing." He's like, "Oh yeah," and he's like, "It's okay. I see a lot of little boy penises." And he just like went to work, and I was just standing there, and I was like, fuck it, was that? Like, did he just say that? He's so casual, and I zipped up real quick.
Did he make his Snapchat name
public?
He's
now in jail.
What happened?
Yeah, he's gone now.
But I get it. Like they have to deal with like rough stuff every day, and I'm sure it feels nice after, you know, tons of dying people to like crack some jokes. But each individual encounter is like so rare for the other side of it.
Yeah.
Like he does that all the time, but not every time is someone else in hospital.
Yeah, I've seen it.
No, you have? Somebody made a troll thing. So you got a new troll doll today?
I threw it away. Is it the same one from the control room? Yeah. But I had a new one when I walked into my office this morning.
So how long did you really? Going on?
Yeah, and then
is it harassment?
Put up the camera.
And then I did that to it. I cut off its hair and I hung it.
Oh,
you and then you don't see this. I didn't take a picture of it, but I put up a sign that said "Trolls ye be warned," like from Pirates of the Caribbean of all the hanging pirates, and it says "Pirates ye be warned."
This was at about the point that I stop doing Fart Hoover because it's like people are getting a little freaked out by it. Yeah, and it's kind of getting a little stalkery.
I feel like this is a very Fart Hoover-esque, although I have a clue as to who it is, and I'm gonna work from there.
Oh,
who is it?
Who?
It's someone who my brother knows, because my brother told me he knew who it was.
Interesting.
That narrows it down.
Not really.
Does your brother know a lot of people?
He does know a lot of people.
I mean, I know Steven.
Yeah, it reminds me. He's like, I get Facebook. This is really bad. I'm starting to really judge people I'm friends with on Facebook, because when I get like random requests, I'm like, who is this person? And I go over to mutual friends, and I see it's always the same list of people that are like,
I can name them right now.
So I'm starting to judge my friends in that manner.
We friends on Facebook?
Yes.
Oh, we are?
I remember, because I think I told this on the podcast, I tried to add you, and it was like, Kevin Free has too many friend requests, but you are now following him. And I was like, fuck that. So I unfollowed you. And I was like, if he's too good to be my friend, I'm not going to follow him. And then you added me later.
Oh, I was going to ask this earlier. Can I
unfriend
people on Xbox and they wouldn't know it? Because we talked about I was talking about the favorites earlier.
I think it's Twitter, where they have to go to their list to see if you've unfriended them.
Is that the one it is? Okay. I'm afraid people would notice. It's like, but then I don't care about, I really only want to know when you're online.
I have a question. There are some people who have Twitter and know when someone unfollows them.
They check it.
But these are not people with like, you know, just a few. It's usually people who have a lot of people they follow or followers.
Websites you can go to. Tells you who like recently
unfollowed.
But then
like, would that person have to go to that website like every day?
Is there a website I can go to that says who follows who? Like, I can type in Gavin and Barbara. Says Gavin follows Barbara.
I think if you go to his profile.
I sort of scroll through all this bullshit.
Yeah.
Here's how people usually know that they've been unfollowed. Because in the people you may know section will pop up someone that who you previously were like linked to.
That's probably it.
Like, that's the way
it's ratting you out. That's what's happening.
I just unfollowed one of my best friends, like one of my longest childhood friends. Still love the guy. He will not stop tweeting about fucking Texas A&M football or sports, and I don't give a shit
just
about
mute
that.
Him.
And then he's like, "Oh, fuck you, T," and stuff like that. And I was like, "Ah, I'm gonna follow you."
Although, yeah.
But I love you.
Real
Ryan.
Friends don't matter. Internet friends matter.
Well, no, it's we're still friends in real life.
No, just kidding.
I always laugh whenever people get mad at me if I unfollow them on Twitter because it's happened before.
Bedbugs.
Oh yeah, those are bedbugs.
Someone gave us a reference to the size of bedbugs.
Yeah, that's
totally visible. You can see the legs and segments and all that stuff.
That's a photo that they took from their house.
It's the size of an
from
ant. It's
bedbugs.
A fat ant is what it is. It just bites.
That's
you.
The name of my new band.
Fat
Did
ant.
You ever see the the dust mites? The microscopic view of what is that?
Bedbugs.
Bunch of bedbugs on top of a nickel.
Oh okay, there's a little one. Little baby ones.
I will give $5 to the first person who can name the building on the back of the nickel.
Congress.
Oh my God. You guys are foreigners, so
that's the
House of Representatives.
That's the
George Clooney's mansion.
That's the biosphere.
That is the Jefferson Memorial.
I knew that.
Yeah, sure you did. You know,
got a dome.
So why does he get that and Lincoln gets a stick?
Lincoln's got a big fucking statue of him on a throne.
Washington has a stick.
Washington.
Oh,
I was gonna say, do you not know the giant throne?
Washington is a city. This whole city's named after the dude.
Is that the big pole? Is Washington?
Washington Monument, yeah.
It's what is that actually? An what is it called?
Obelisk.
Obelisk?
Yeah, I think you got it right.
called an obelisk, Gavin. That thing always gets killed. That's like.
Oh, yeah.
What are the buildings that always get it?
It's I'll tell you what the most destroyed building ever is.
What?
The Capitol Records building in Los Angeles. The round tower. It's what they're standing on Independence Day when they fucking blast down on it.
It's the Maze Bank Tower.
What
right?
is Maze Bank?
In GTA. It's what they call that thing.
I haven't played GTA in like 3 years.
Brag about it.
No, I know. You guys play every week, but it's like...
Well, I mean, GTA 5 didn't come out 3 years ago.
It might have been 3 years at this point.
Was it?
Let me see when GTA 5... I haven't played it since like a month after it came out. I didn't even make it to when they got to multiplayer. GTA 5 release date was...
I thought it was 2013.
2014.
2014? Release date.
Probably totally wrong on that.
September 17th, 2013.
Ooh.
Oh, damn.
So we're at 2.5 years. We're coming up in our third
year. Was that when we were filming The Gauntlet?
That's fucking crazy.
Yeah,
it was. I remember Michael.
God damn it.
Everybody.
Miles was like, yeah.
Michael was playing it on his...
Games.
System.
Games.
Freddie was playing it.
Kovic, I think.
Yeah.
That's when I first met Kovic and Greg.
It's a great game.
Me too.
It's a great game.
It's and a
now,
masterpiece.
Yeah.
Both Kovic and Greg work with us.
I used to be a huge Adam Kovic fan, and then to meet him and him not know who I was, and then now we're friends. It's really weird.
You're friends.
Is Lauren around? But didn't we know if Lauren's here? I had a funny experience with Lauren. She's on my
Crozier?
Friends list for Xbox. She's not one of the people.
Lauren Crozier?
Yes.
Is she the one with the bedbugs?
No, stop it. This is a long time ago. You don't start like naming people and pinning that on. Absolutely
she
not.
Might be here. I don't know.
She wasn't at the Congress office. But she was playing Division. I was playing Division.
You just gave away.
What did I say? I said it was at the Congress office before.
All right.
Sorry. It's an anonymous source. I'm going to protect my source of bedbugs. So we were playing Division, and you could see your friends on a map, and normally you could set A to like go like, I want a waypoint to go find that person. Like, or a point on the map, you hit A to do it.
What game
but
is
if,
this?
Division.
Yeah, yeah.
But on the map, but if you go over one of your friends and hit A, you just automatically join their group. Not only just don't invite them, you just like, it assumes because you're friends, you want to be in groups together. All of a sudden, you're in a group together.
Next to her?
So I was going to go like see what kind of gear she had. So she was like 2 blocks away from me. So I hit A to set a waypoint to go find her. But it joined me into her group. And then she signed out of the game and logged off Xbox. Like immediately. And I haven't seen her since then. I'm like, I must have really fucking creeped her out or something. I don't know what happened, but it was like she was gone off of Xbox completely. Like within 2 seconds.
It's probably just a coincidence.
Yeah, within like, it was like 2 seconds. It was enough time for me to realize what had happened. I go, oh, I joined the group. And I was like, I wonder if I like was going to think, should I get my microphone? She's gone. Boop. Off.
Have you been playing it pretty fair amount, Division?
I would say I've been playing that. Yeah, that's probably the first game in a long time. I feel like I'm playing a new game.
Yeah.
Like as in the month it came out.
I went into the Dark Zone for the first time.
Fucking Dark Zone is the best.
Yeah, and I immediately got killed by these two dudes who I watched them kill another guy, and I was watching them from afar, and I was like, maybe they won't notice me, I'll get away. They turned around and killed me, so I was like, fuck these guys. So I went in, and I started shooting at them, and I got one of them down, the other one started, he got him up, and he started catching up, and I was like, fuck, I'm gonna die. The guy that they killed earlier came in, and then we teamed up on them without ever
moments.
Communicating. And I was like, this is the coolest gaming experience ever.
That's awesome.
It's very, Dark Zone is very well done. The way they do the extractions, I think I talked about it on the podcast. I talked about it on the post show or the podcast.
Yeah, you talked about it, yeah.
Yeah, it's really great. What level are you in Division?
Oh, I think like 18 or 19.
The level or Dark Zone level? Because there's two levels.
Oh, Dark Zone level, probably. I think I'm in the low teens.
I'm at a 20.
We could get the fuck out of here. So we should play and I'll fucking.
I don't know why. I just can't put it in. I can't bring myself to put that game in.
Why?
You know how there's a game.
You liked Destiny a lot. It's whatever Destiny is. They don't want you to call it an MMO. It's whatever Destiny is. That's what the Division is.
Is that just this unnamed genre
it
of
is.
Gaming now?
It's the
it's a, RPG
it's
FPS.
It's just a game. It's not an
RPG shooter.
It has loot and it has levels.
It has like
and it has gear and modifiers.
Blue, purple, and orange.
Yeah, and you have stats for your character, but it's not an MMO.
I'm
very clear.
I've just been playing the same level in Hitman over and over again.
Have you really?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's your game, though. You love Hitman.
I don't really. I mean, this one's okay. I just wish I could play more of it. But I am happy I beat Jeremy to 1,000,000.
Oh, that was crazy.
I also feel awful about
it. Explain to the audience what that is, just so not everybody follows like the Twitter accounts and all
that
stuff.
Yeah, Jeremy had a video. It's an achievement guide or an Easter egg guide in Fallout 4.
This is on Achievement Hunter's YouTube channel.
On the Achievement Hunter channel. And for months, it's been the most viewed on the Achievement Hunter channel. It's a relatively new channel, so we don't have any over 1,000,000 views yet. And for 4 months, his has been the front runner to hit that spot. It had the most views. And the day before his video hit 1,000,000 views, I snuck a video in and it got 1,000,000 views. But literally, a day later, his hit 1,000,000.
Yeah.
And I feel so bad about it. But also, I feel kind of good about
that
it.
That is in such true Achievement Hunter fashion, though.
Yeah. So I tweeted a picture of me with like the smuggest face possible, like full nostril flare. Yeah. It actually hurt. It hurt my neck and my face to do that.
Whenever I see you doing that face in a picture, I go, ugh. Like audibly.
So smug.
It's so annoying. I just want to punch you every time you do that face.
I whip it out on special occasions. But yeah, it went on the front page of Reddit, and within 2 days, it had 1,000,000 views.
Now you just gotta get that rage quit up. I can't.
Go ahead, one more time.
Rage quit up.
Third time's a charm.
To 1,000,000.
I'm being told via Twitter that I was sort of incorrect. I'm not gonna acknowledge full incorrectness.
Spiderweb.
That the building on the back of the nickel is Monticello. It's Jefferson's estate, not the Jefferson Memorial, which I believe was the inspiration for the architecture of the Jefferson Memorial. So. Oh, in fact, at one point in my life, I thought Monticello was the name of the Jefferson Memorial, but it's not. What else were we going to... I was going to say one more thing before we took off.
We have two things to still talk about.
Yeah, let's talk about the Ruby Tug screenings really quick. Go ahead.
Yeah. Ruby?
Yep.
So we're doing Tug screenings for Ruby Volume 1. So if you live in, I think it's US, Canada, New Zealand, Australia, the UK...
Beacon.
I think that's it. But we're doing screenings all over there. And you could buy a ticket in your city for April 27th or 30th to go see Ruby Volume 1. There's going to be bonus videos of unreleased Rooster Teeth stuff.
Ooh.
You're going to get a 25% discount to the store.
Some trailers.
And cool you'll find out who had bed bugs.
And you're going to get access to, I think, an exclusive Ruby
You'll
item.
Get bed bugs. We'll give you bed bugs at the screen.
Is that illegal?
So it's teamruby.com.
Just a jug of bed bugs.
Yeah. Splash.
You get like a mason jar.
That's like the new sparkling somewhere.
That was the most interesting thing about that Invisible World show was the microscopic image of dust mites and how they look like massive, like grazing elephants, but they're like little tiny.
And your eyelashes, they look all segmented and everything.
Yeah, and there's even like a little worm that lives in the roots of your eyelashes. And it's the only place they are on your body.
I hate thinking about that.
You have them right now.
The
right
craziest
there.
Thing about scale to me that shows the difference in scale that we don't have any kind of concept or perception for is the fact that if you took the Earth down and shrunk it down to the size of a cue ball on a pool table, it would be smoother than a cue ball.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But just by the variations, standard deviations they allow on the surface of a cue ball, those are greater than the overall surface of the Earth, like the Marianas Trench and the Mount Everest. Damn
it'd
it.
Be a heavy cue ball.
I was going to ask.
It'd be a dirty cue ball, too.
You think it would be dense?
What? The Earth?
Why would it be?
Oh, never mind. I thought you were saying if it maintained the weight, but the size of a cue ball. I'm an idiot.
No, you're fine. Listen, we got to get something wrong in the astrophysics arena at least once a podcast. What else we need to talk about besides Ruby?
Kind of Funny.
Oh, yeah. Kind of Funny joined the Rooster Teeth family.
Yay!
Kind of Funny is now a part of the Let's Play Network. They asked yours truly to host the Kind of Funny Live event, Kind of Funny Live 2, that there's they are hosting in...
Tim Little Getty's there.
Yeah. And
he is.
Look at his look at those smug guys. Face.
So happy. So this is the first Kind of Funny that they did, and they're going to be holding Kind of Funny Live 2. And we'll have lots of people from Rooster Teeth there. I'll be emceeing the first night. So it should be a lot of fun. And
tickets are on sale.
Tickets are on sale right now. Couldn't be happier about having those guys on board. We're actually doing some merch stuff with them, too. We have Kind of Funny shirts now in the Rooster Teeth store. You guys should definitely come and see it all and get a shirt. Support the guys from Kind of Funny. They're fucking awesome. And we've known them for a really long time. Back when some of them worked at IGN. I think all of them at one point did. They were in the Gauntlet Season 2. So now Gauntlet Season 2.
We're just hiring the entire cast of the Gauntlet.
Eventually, hopefully, we'll get there. We just got to figure out a way to do something with iJustine and Freddy next.
We got Josh and Stan from Contestants, didn't we?
The first season of the Gauntlet, yeah. They were the community team for the second season.
Not Josh, but Stan was.
Josh was first season, right?
Yeah. Josh was the runner-up.
He lost a $10,000 game of Tetris. Unfucking believable.
Yeah, but
he got a job at Rooster Teeth.
Yeah.
Can't put
I'm
a price
sure
on
he's
that.
He's made at least $10,000 by now.
Yeah, who else didn't we hire from that? Let's get them all. Let's get Freddy.
Someone just corrected me as saying Washington is also on a throne for his monument, but they spelled throne like throwing a football. So thanks for the correction. Thanks for the correction there. That was nice.
Do you dislike the
Don't
fact
worry,
that
I will
guy...
not call you out by name, Russ Bruce.
That guy knows more than you, but he can't smell.
We only make fun because we love you. That's
it's John Reisinger. Yeah, I love those guys. I probably watch their content, other than ours, I probably watch their content the most out of any other YouTube creator.
Who? Kind
of
Funny.
Kind of Funny, yeah. I love their podcasts. Ow, my knuckle.
Almost got it.
Yeah, we got the whole debate. So before we go, I want to talk about one last thing. I just finished my favorite type of game, which are open world games. And the reason I like those are the easiest games to play on treadmill, like GTA 5. Fallout 4. Have you played the Fallout 4 DLC yet, bud?
I have not.
How about anybody else?
It's about robots.
You played it all?
I don't do Fallout.
Okay, yeah.
You're a fool.
That DLC's not exciting me in the least, though, I gotta say.
I want to do what I did with Fallout 3, and that's wait for all of it to come out and play all
and
the DLC.
Binge it?
Yeah, and then I'll probably be playing for as long as I originally did.
One thing I gotta say about Bethesda, and the Fallout franchise in particular, is they do good DLC, and it's big, but the game is still massive. Like, the game, I don't feel like there's anything left out of the game to hold back for DLC. Like, the games themselves are enormous.
Yeah.
Even playing all those DLCs back-to-back, it'll be a huge experience. It won't be anywhere near what playing the full Fallout 4 was. I don't think.
But the original one had, like, new areas you could go to.
The original one? Was even Fallout 3?
Fallout 3. The ones that count. That nobody original. Played Fallout 2.
My brother was a huge Fallout fan.
Oh, really?
The way I said it, it sounded like my brother was in the past tense. He's always been a huge Fallout fan.
I watched some speedruns of Fallout 2, 1 and 2, and they're very different games.
Doesn't Hellboy, like, do the voice for something?
No, he just did the narration for the opening of Fallout
3. Ron Perlman?
Yeah, does he do Perlman. All of them?
Just not 4.
Why?
War never changes, that whole thing?
Yeah, why didn't he...
So
why
someone in there knows
you know
a lot of
Halo
shit
he was in Halo
tonight.
As well.
What was he?
Ron Perlman.
He was in Halo 2 and 3.
Good job, Nick.
What was he?
The Arbiter.
Lord Hood.
Oh, he was shit. He's a good voice actor.
And he was in Sons of Anarchy.
No, I know that. I used to watch that show.
Oh, you did?
Yeah. His hands was all busted, and he was married to Leela from Futurama.
Yeah, he was. I'm a Son of Anarchy.
What do you like
people
a fan?
Tell me people tell me the Earth's coming, I'm forgetting the water. I'm not forgetting the water. The Mariana's Trench is in the ocean.
So would it be like
the deepest
ball,
part?
Would the ball be
the
like
biggest
wet?
Variations on the surface of the Earth are the Mariana's Trench. And the tip of Mount Everest.
What would you want
to
do?
That's the biggest variation.
Would you like to spend a day
yes.
on a planet that was a blown up cube ball?
Just a white planet?
Sounds terrible.
No, but you could see like obviously it would be very mountainous and trenchy.
Oh, yeah. You could just do that with a microscope, couldn't you? Right?
Surface the size of the Earth?
Surface of a cube ball? Just see what it's like?
Well, the horizon's like 12 miles away, right? So could you make...
The answer to your question is yes. I would love to spend a day on a different planet with no repercussions. Yes. The answer is yes.
Would you want to summit Mount Everest or go to the bottom of the
Summit
Mariana's
Mount
Trench?
Everest.
I would want to go to the bottom of the Mariana's Trench.
There's only been one dude who's ever done it.
You'd be crushed.
Nobody's done it.
One dude's done it.
You would get crushed.
Who did it?
James Cameron did it.
But he hasn't been... I think maybe a submarine
went,
or
like
camera.
He sent a drone down there, didn't he?
No. James Cameron went down to the bottom of the Marianas Trench.
What, he stood there?
Bull.
Oh, dude,
no.
Was he dressed in a big daddy
suit?
Must
have been like in a, like, a tank, but like reinforced.
What's the
like,
pressure at what down point, there?
At what point do you become a vehicle? Like, you can wear a suit.
I'm
like,
saying you're wrong, too. It's Marianas Trench. I keep saying Marianas Trench. I've said that since I was a little kid. Marianas, yeah. So, Deep Sea Challenger. Okay, you fuckers. He's Canadian, Barbara. You should know this. Deep Sea Challenger is a 7.3-meter deep-diving submersible designed to reach the bottom of Challenger Deep, the deepest known point on Earth. On March 26, 2012, Canadian film director James Cameron piloted the craft to accomplish this goal in the second manned dive, reaching the Challenger Deep. Who's the first dude? I thought only one dude had ever been down there.
That's horrifying.
Maybe it was Ridley Scott.
Built in Sydney, Australia by the research and design company... What the? Who's the first dude? Okay, I'll look at this other thing. Anyway, so we'll look this up for later.
That's happened?
Get another... Yeah, there's two dudes apparently that have already done it.
That's see, crazy. If I was the first guy on the moon, I would try and be the
nothing
first guy.
Nothing down there, by the way. Nothing. It's just dirt and
monsters.
Pressure.
And like those
dragons. Monsters.
Those glow-in-the-dark fish.
What about going to the bottom of the ocean?
Dinosaurs.
The glow-in-the-dark that fish, the he left those like a mile back.
I mean, like...
Probably.
The how one many miles down
to
down
a point
is
where you could actually survive.
The eye on the stalk, that
yeah
thing?
Yeah. About it?
Long gone.
Would you rather go like see that? To a point where you could actually survive.
Then go to Everest?
Yeah.
If I could... I want to see animals that haven't been seen, which I'm sure that there are...
There's a lot in the ocean.
They exist.
Dude, as a joke, if I was on James Cameron's ship as a crew member, when he, like, dunked into the water, the moment he dunked in the water, I would have dropped his car keys down into the Marianas Trench. Wouldn't it be funny to go all the way down to the bottom of the Marianas Trench and go, it's my fucking car keys right there.
They're saying the heart of the ocean.
I've been looking for those.
Yeah, how is there not a bunch of crap down there?
I don't know.
There's got to be. It'd probably get crushed. I bet a lot of it gets crushed by the time
it gets there.
Did you
ever talk about what happened at the immersion chute?
Which one?
With the jetpacks?
Holy shit. No, we never did talk about that.
Yeah, that was crazy.
So when we were at the jetpack immersion, Chris crashed his jetpack into the water, and he hit it with such force that he went down into the water, like, or onto the ground at the bottom, and it snapped off his GoPro, and he came back
up. Which
we've
been filming with all day.
Yeah, and he was like, oh, wow, that was great. Fuck, like, the GoPro's gone, it has all my footage, and we'd just gotten a great take, and we're like, shit, so, like...
But it wasn't the end of the world.
It kind of was, because
it was
all of his coverage, yeah.
It was, yeah.
So, like, it was, like, me, him, our DP, and, like, one other person, we all put on wetsuits, and we just started searching around, and we could not find this fucking GoPro.
And I was on the shore going, you guys are fucking lunatics,
I'm
not
gonna find
it.
It's done, and then I remember Jason Harder, our DP, like, was like, what? He grew it up, and he's like... Ah, and then just everybody just started screaming. We were like beasts, like cavemen. We were just like so excited.
Well, I finally thought you guys were never going to find that.
And we had that moment on footage, like him pulling it up and us just like freaking out. It was.
You should post that. That's a great RT life.
It's easily one of the happiest moments on a shoot that I've ever had.
Yeah, just all you guys cheering. I remember
because it's still filming, right?
They should have tracking beeper thingies on those GoPros.
I agree. They get lost a lot, or they get shot with fucking cannons.
If it's in the water, how would you hear it?
Yeah.
Or you like just, a, like track with your phone,
like sonar, like a tile.
Yeah, Dan shot one with a cannon.
Oh, here it is.
That's from the immersion episode. That's the we're showing clip now of Chris
that
riding
like
the
well
water
fun
jetpack.
So it's like it whenever that so camera's looking fun at him, that's the one that.
Dude,
got lost.
All I gotta say is you made him look way more graceful than he was in real life.
That was fucking hard.
His
that was
legs
not easy.
You guys were blasted by the end of that thing.
I tried the we had there's a like a skateboard thing that had two water jets coming out of it that would lift you up straight up and you'd have no support. The boots were like made of this hard plastic and I have really tiny, like awkwardly small feet that wouldn't fit in the boots. So my feet were just kind of like hanging out in there. And so I couldn't get my balance straight and I just kept whipping like whiplash into the water.
Well, that was also like a freezing cold day pretty much.
I couldn't breathe.
And I remember like you were out there like doing it and stuff like that on the lake. And then like you came back and you're like, hey, good job, Barbara. And you're like, like you were like near death and we're like, oh my god,
it's,
get her out of the water.
It's because I fell down so hard onto my stomach from about 50 feet in the air.
Knock the wind out.
What are we doing?
Oh, what's happened?
Oh, it's gone.
Oh, nice catch.
Oh, that's it. Oh, I took the table all the way to the end of the podcast to crash. Thank you for joining us on this edition of the Rooster Teeth podcast. We have no idea what happened
slide
to the table. Sorry. Don't forget, we're currently getting together screenings for Ruby on Tug, and want to give a shout out to the guys at Kinda Funny for being the latest addition to our family.
Love you.
Love you guys.